We should say, "Oh, Captain, my Captain," or something.
Oh, Captain, my Captain.
Sally forth, Sally ho!
See, I did that last time, and everybody looked at me like I was a weirdo. Like,
I don't want you to pick up any sand. I looked at him like a weirdo.
Point it into the void.
That's true, you did.
Nothing there. Boy, you buy the pumpkin beer, and everyone shows up.
That's right. All four of your friends.
Yep.
I'm not even drinking pumpkin beer.
Nope.
I'm not even your friend.
You should probably just get out.
She's not denying it.
No.
So
yes,
welcome.
Wait, what?
Yeah, who are we and why are we here?
So
who
welcome.
Who is your daddy and what does he do?
Wow.
Good, yeah.
I don't know if good and no, just.
Ooh. That's
pretty good.
It was a good impression.
Thank
it
you.
It was good.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Threading and Dreading. We have a pretty full house tonight. We're going to get a list of these movie trailers and a little bit of future presentations. And to my right, we have.
The Goddess of Gore.
And how are you?
I can't think of anything right now.
Okay.
I'm undecided currently.
Yes.
Kim.exe has stopped working.
Error.
Error. Yeah. Error.
404, emotion not found.
All right. Well, you've got a pumpkin brew. You're doing better.
Yeah.
And to her right, we have?
Pretty sure I'm the Black Lantern.
Yes, you are.
All right, I'm learning. All right, that's teamwork.
And how are you doing?
I'm fantastic. I got a beer. I'm good.
Yeah. With your, is it okay?
Broken finger.
No,
broken
hand. No, no. I was going to say, are you able to hold it well enough?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
I'm good.
That's a strong hand.
Yeah.
Strong hand.
We were saying on the last podcast, you know, you had such a good time at the fangirl's wedding that you just broke your hand in enjoyment.
Yeah, not that good a time. I mean, like, it wasn't like that kind of good time. You know what I mean? I had a great time, don't get me wrong, but it wasn't like that kind of good time. Air quotes.
Right.
Hey, I had to drive home, okay? Kind of. Wasn't that kind of rodeo. Move on from me.
And next to the Black Lantern we have.
I think you should just keep talking.
Let him die. Let him die.
Slowly burning.
Keep talking till the embers finally burn out.
Next to the Black Lantern we have.
The Fangirl Extraordinaire.
And how are you?
Good.
Good.
Yeah.
Sorry, we didn't have any Dark and Stormies ready. They're chilling right now.
No, that's totally fine. I drink too much on weekdays anyway.
That's true.
Yeah, you do.
Yep.
Got two people backing you up there.
Someone's got it. Real nice. I like that. And next to the fangirl we have?
The Dystopian.
How are you, sir?
Very well. I'm in, you know, I'm in control of my emotions. I can say how I'm doing pretty readily.
Yay. Yeah.
It's going to hurt sometimes.
The last time you were here, you were a fragile piece of glass.
That's true.
Are you okay now?
That was that long ago?
I know. Yeah.
It was a month ago, right?
I thought he was here before, like, since then.
No, we've only recorded once since then.
The last time I was here, you were here.
Yeah. I'm much better now.
Good.
I've mended, yes.
Good.
I'm more like a piece of sheet metal now.
Ah,
you're like
sheet metal. Moving on up.
You're like an iPhone screen now.
No, those iPhones bend. You don't want to be that.
Well, they fortified the glass now.
Fortified the glass.
So you can throw it at a bull, and like it'll probably still be fine.
Yeah, I don't want any parts of that. But
so we can throw to the Dystopian.
Is it like
I don't know?
Okay, we should try.
There's
that.
A lot involved there that we don't have access to.
Is it like those old Nokia phones that you can, you know, put them in a wood chipper
bricks.
And they wouldn't break?
You can run it over with a
oh my God.
Tractor and it's fine.
Remember, there was a competition on it was like Street Games or something on MTV a while back, and Street Games, where they basically
sounds
would,
familiar.
It was like the game was they'd give you like $100 to see how far you could throw your phone.
That's a good game.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow, that's dumb.
But back then, you know, you're getting the Nokias for.
Right,
dirt cheap.
And I remember they had these like four or five people lined up to see how far they could throw their phone, and every time they throw their phone, the phones would just shatter into a million pieces when they land. Except for the last guy who had a Nokia, he chucked that thing, you know, like 50, 60 yards each time. It would just land, bounce off the concrete, go back, get to throw it again, throw it again, because the thing would never break.
Uh-huh.
Wow. Oh, they, it was supposed to break?
Well, no, they said you can keep throwing it until it breaks.
Oh.
But he just kept throwing it. The thing wouldn't
amazing,
break.
Yeah. Little tiny screen so you could play Snake for
Snake for hours.
I downloaded a Snake app on my phone, actually.
You're going to have to show me that.
It's
And earlier when I said we weren't going to digress, I was wrong. That is awesome.
It actually looks like the Nokia.
Holy crap.
That's great.
Everybody download the Snake app now.
Wow. That's great.
That is fantastic. Holy crap.
Yeah. That's fun.
It's awesome.
Dude, I'm stealing
this podcast
phone.
Brought to you by Nokia.
And iPhone. And everybody else we've endorsed already.
Okay, quick timeout.
And Netflix and Cinemark. $5 Tuesdays.
La Taqueria at the Wilmington Riverfront Market from 4 to 6 p.m. Happy hour.
And Harpoon Oktoberfest. We don't get in trouble.
Brought to you by Calgon.
Stuff, brought to you by Sun Chips.
Calgon, take me away.
And he opens his eyes.
What was?
He opens his eyes.
There was a,
and he opens his eyes.
There was like a misspelled text message or something.
Yeah.
And there was the girl like sitting in the tub, so all you saw was the legs, you know, like the down shot. And it says, Calvin, take me away. And she's like, damn it, Calgon!
That was Steve Harvey's wife.
That's It was Steve Harvey that retweeted it.
Yeah.
Yep.
Nice. About to say, your brother's in trouble if that's what's
going on.
Calvin,
one.
Take me away.
Or he's doing really well for himself.
Oh, he's doing well for himself.
Sounds like he's doing fine.
Agreed. before we get into the trailers, there's something that I wanted to bring up with the goddess and something we had over the weekend, which was our visit to Jason.
Oh,
the
Everybody buckle up.
Yeah, I'm going to just lay my microphone down.
Yeah.
You know, we won't touch on it long. But
no, I mean,
oh, what, only 20 minutes?
Specifically called her out.
Giggity.
Oh, just like me and the goddess, you know, that's
Hey, guys, want to go out for a smoke?
Sorry, I don't have to talk about
it. Talk about it.
Oh, shut up and talk about it. Waste
your
some
show,
more time.
Damn it.
Yeah.
Do whatever you want.
Don't make me take this away from you. I'll do it.
What? It's our podcast now. We've commandeered your podcast.
That's right. Mutiny on the
Mutiny! Board. Pirate Day. Oh, we missed Pirate Day.
Oh, yeah.
September 20th?
I don't know.
September 19th, I think?
I don't know, man.
Yeah.
Not today.
Not today. About a month ago.
Today is not that day.
Anyway.
We digress.
So, for those of you who live on the East Coast, do you know that there are a ton of haunted attractions around, you know, the Mid-Atlantic region, and the one we went to over the weekend was Jason's Woods. Now, we went there because we had heard good things from relatives and friends, and we had never been there before, and the goddess has been to many more than I have. I mean, let's rattle off some. I mean, we've got...
God.
Well, okay, so, Frightland. Bates Motel, Eastern State, Pennhurst,
Ghost of the Jujubee.
Definitely been to that one.
What did you say, Ghost of the Jujubee?
Yes.
What the fuck is Ghost of the Jujubee?
Language.
Yeah, jeez, man. Can't say Jujubee on the radio.
Radio.
Go home.
The radio star.
Get out.
I mean, they're Creamy Acres, Scare
That's
Brothers.
That's just the name of the farm. That's not the name of the farm.
What is that?
You very said scary.
Creamy Acres.
I shit you not. The farm is Creamy Acres, and you'll never guess which state it's in.
It's like Pennsylvania?
It's Jersey.
Of course.
It's like Smokestack Acres.
Yeah. But there's Scare Brothers. Is that Scare Brothers? Is that?
Yeah, I don't think that one's around anymore.
Shocktoberfest.
Yeah.
And I know I'm missing a ton, but we had never been to Jason's Woods before. So we get there, and it's, you know, a decent line to get tickets. Then they take
We got to cut because my aunt was there already.
So you're those people.
Yep.
Yeah. Good. Very good.
But we get through line, and we, you know, get the tickets for all six attractions, as they call it.
Mm-hmm.
But one of the ones that wasn't included on the ticket was this free pre-show thing that you go into.
That you have to do.
That you have to do. Like, you have to start off with this. We're like, okay. So you go in, and they put, like, 80, 90 people in this room. And there's this big screen in front of you where they have a, like, a projector set up. And there's this woman talking to you the whole time. And then they start showing you this movie. And the whole time, the woman's talking over the movie. So you can't hear a fucking thing that the movie is, like, saying. You're just like, all you're hearing is this woman talking. So it's almost like a really, really bad version of Mystery Science Theater, except not funny at all.
Yeah.
So shortly after that, we're shuttled out, and we get in line for the first attraction, which was, what, nearly a two-hour wait? Was that what we timed it as?
No, that one was about an hour.
an hour.
That we stood in one spot.
For one spot, yeah. Because they had, for those of you who go to, you know, like Disney, Universal, whatever, they have the Fast Pass thing, you know, which is a whole other thing of bullshit. But every...
Hate it.
Yeah, it's terrible. But every amusement park does it now.
The Disney one is okay.
Disney one is good, that yeah.
Sense, it's still annoying.
Because you just put your ticket in.
Yeah, everyone gets one. It. Yeah.
I know anybody can do it. You get like three a day or whatever.
Yeah.
Right, it's still
really annoying.
Yeah,
well, because
everybody picks it for the same damn ride, and you're like, well,
right.
I didn't pick it.
But it, but it's not like
9 years.
Yeah,
but it's not like Universal or SeaWorld or others where you have to pay more to cut in front of everyone. You know,
correct.
That's ridiculous.
I think Disney makes just enough money to let them
right.
do that.
Maybe.
Brought to you by Disney.
So they did this at Jason's Woods and had the VIP pass, which you pay like $65 and you get to cut to the front of the line at each time. Yeah, which is ridiculous. At most parks, what they do is, okay, they let the VIPs go through, but then they let some of the regular line go through.
They
go
don't
like back
empty
and forth.
Out the
it's
whole
like construction.
VIP lane.
Yeah, right. Yeah, you go back
right.
and forth.
You go, some,
you
go. Right.
Some, you go, let
exactly.
Some,
you go. What they do at Jason's Woods is, oh, if there's a VIP in line, they go in front of you, regardless. So
no matter how long the
no matter how long
is.
The line is for the regulars. So we sat in that line not moving because VIPs kept going into that line.
And then they kept coming.
Exactly.
Yeah, they kept emptying out of this
giggity.
Quote unquote theater.
It's gonna be my new thing. I just made that up.
Nice.
So
yeah. Yeah. So finally we get in through this one attraction that was like 3 minutes long and it was god awful. And then we get into another line, which is for the hayride. And we were in line for that for about an hour. And again, the whole time, the VIPs are cutting in front of us.
Every attraction was just awful.
Yeah.
They reused the same actors.
Yeah. Oh, that's
between
another
the
thing.
Hayride
right.
and the other thing.
Jeff the Pirate.
Yeah. You know, when you go to Frightland or Penhurst or whatever, when you go
just
through a ride.
With a chainsaw.
Yeah. When you go through any other attraction.
He lives there.
That's
Uncle Carl.
Exactly. You're only going to see, like, one actor once the whole night. Like, if you see someone dressed up as Leatherface or Jason or whatever, you're only going to see him once. But what they did at Jason's Woods is they doubled up where when you go through, like, the haunted maze or whatever, it's the back.
Wasn't haunted.
Yeah, it was. Yeah. Yeah. It was the backside of the hayride. So all you're doing is seeing all the hayride stuff again.
Specifically speaking, I believe I heard that Frightland, on average, uses about 250 characters?
Actors. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Each night.
Right.
Right.
So
I think
every night that they run, there's 250
right.
actors
yeah.
that they use.
I right. think Jason's Woods had 30.
Yeah. And yeah.
Maybe. At least that's what it felt like.
Mm-hmm. And to supplement not having to pay actors, they bought a bunch of animatronics that look corny as hell. Yeah. Like you walk into the first tent and there's like this big bat thing in the corner that's not moving, but as soon as they activate it, it just starts flapping slowly. That, yeah, yeah, exactly.
Not even quick like a bat would do. It's just like, whoom, whoom,
right.
Whoom, whoom. All right, get away.
Right. It looks
privacy.
It looks awful. And I'm like, I'm sorry, the animatronics aren't scary. I want a real actor, you
yeah.
know?
A beaver?
That's a bat.
No, it's a bat. Everybody knows
come
that.
Come on,
no. What does the bat say?
I don't know. That says much.
Fap, 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 fap.
It's not a fapping bat, okay? It's a flapping
anyway.
Bat.
No, 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 no. Fat bat.
So we... I like it.
Oh, wow. Oh, wow.
I think you broke her.
You need to test her mic again. Just adjust that thing, because now Will called it.
No, you really did.
Volume's getting up there.
But after we went through that, there was like a big wooded area, which we were cold getting off the hayride, but your body temperature skyrocketed because they're making you like hike through these hills to like go through like the backwoods area, which again wasn't that scary. And I'll sum it up. It was really, really bad. It was just awful.
Yeah,
and
big letdown.
I've never been to an attraction where I just left and I was like, I don't think I was genuinely scared the whole night.
Yeah.
You know? The best thing was
the worst one I've ever been to.
The best thing they had was good pyrotechnics. Like going through the hayride, they had really good like flames and explosions that were actually pretty impressive. But
and it warmed you up.
It warmed you up. It didn't scare you, it just warmed you up.
I mean, the day after, or was it the day after you guys
Yeah.
Went, yeah. Mm-hmm. The day after you guys went, the goddess and I went for a walk. Delrec, and we walked a little later than we thought we would, and she was like, it was scarier going through the park than it was going through Jason's Woods, because we heard something in the bushes, and then we just started running.
This is
like,
real. We have no- this is not a drill.
And then we were just walking regular, and someone just passed us, and she scared the shit out of me.
Yeah, she was awesome. There was this girl who was just running next to her, and then, like, we were in the middle... We were in the middle of talking about I can't remember why somebody was rocking back and forth, and then like I thought she was going down to like demonstrate rocking back and forth, but she was actually just scared, and she just like flinched, and then I got scared because she got scared, and then it was just some runner who was
regular runner.
Okay.
But she was scarier than the people at the haunt.
Right. Like, we've had stuff at our house for Halloween that was scarier than what was happening at this place. So, for those of you who live on the East Coast or Mid-Atlantic, do not go to Jason's Woods. It is not worth the money.
How long have they been open?
30 years.
30 years.
This is their 30
years. My sister said.
they must be operating on, like, reputation alone.
That sounds like BS. Haunted place has been open for 30 years?
Right.
I don't know. I mean, that's what the website says. Right. I know they've been around a while.
Maybe the location's been there or something.
Maybe.
Operating the same thing for 30 years?
But, it was very, very disappointing. I want to go to another one this year just to get the taste of that one out of my mouth.
I'll just make one up. Just come over.
You're not
house.
Supposed to taste it, Michael.
maybe that was the problem.
Yeah. That reminds me, though. We should definitely go... It's not so much a haunted house, but we should definitely do an escape room.
Yeah, you've been mentioning that.
Mm-hmm.
That's a legit thing.
Yeah.
I love downloading
where you have to,
those.
Like, figure out
the... Yeah. No. There are actual things. There's actually one in Newark.
Yep.
So if we get a chance, we should definitely go.
Where you have to, like, figure out the puzzles to get
like
out.
Like, the clues and stuff, and then, like, you know, go and... I don't know. I don't think... It doesn't look like it should be that expensive.
You might be able to, get a Groupon or something.
Yeah.
And then, like, we can go as a group, and I think it would be a lot of fun.
Or I have, you know, one in my basement, so...
Okay, goodbye.
Well, there's
like
a pit
and
everything. It's great.
Puts the lotion on its skin. It does this whenever it's told.
That's not good.
I was telling the fangirl, my aunt said there's one where they have a zombie locked up in the room with you when you're trying to do the puzzle. And as each minute, the leash gets like longer and longer.
Okay. And I was like, there's no way that...
I would love that.
There's no way that would happen, because what would end up happening with that was that I would get super, super freaked out, and I would just start screaming and screaming, and someone would have to, like, just hold me, and then I'd be kicking and punching, and by the end of the whole entire thing, I would be part of the attraction, because I would be the crazy person, like, in the corner of the room, like,
also chained up.
Yeah.
Real nice. Oop,
got another one for you. Put
Real
it in
nice.
The pile.
It's called Main Street's Great Escape.
Oh, okay.
There's like a Sherlock room or something.
Oh, okay.
Sounds kind of cool.
Yeah.
Interesting. Yeah, I'm definitely up for that.
Yeah, I know that there are a couple in Philly, too.
$20
like,
a person.
Okay.
That's not bad.
Much.
Okay.
It's better than Jason's Woods.
Exactly.
Yes, yes, definitely.
They are slashing prices. Halloween reference.
So getting into our trailers, the first one we have is Back in Time.
I was visiting my parents over the summer of 1980, came across my father's high school yearbook. My father had gone to the same high school that I went to. And I'm thinking, if I'd gone to high school with my dad, would I have been friends with him?
It really is, for me, and arguably the greatest time travel movie ever put on film.
If we would have done something different at one moment, would it have changed our whole lives for the better?
I think it's the best thing that I've ever written. I mean, along with Bob, of course.
Zemeckis and Gale really found lightning in a bottle.
You probably have one of those in you in a lifetime.
Lightning in a bottle tends to stick around for a long time.
Here we go, back in time.
Now, if anyone starts discussing Huey Lewis songs, you need to exit the room immediately.
Wait, did he do the Power of Love?
Dude, I'm too hip to be square, okay?
Power of Love. people.
Pretty sure he did.
Yeah, if I start getting an axe and putting down tarps and talking about Huey Lewis.
Putting the poncho on.
Yeah.
If you call someone a yuppie, it's like, okay, I'm out.
Yeah. Start talking about a business card.
Right. Mm-hmm.
My God, it's embossed. Nice. So, this film was actually a successful Kickstarter back last year that raised $140,000. So, it was a pretty successful Kickstarter. I think it was one of the front... It was like one of the banner ones for Kickstarter for a while on the front page.
Hmm.
The director of this is Jason Aaron. And this is his directorial debut. This is his first film. He's only had short films up until this point. Now, the film right now is actually just starting its tour. There's not going to be a nationwide release. They're actually doing this a little bit differently than most documentaries, where it gets, you know, picked up in like an independent circuit and then tours or gets a small release at local theaters. They're actually touring with this. So it's going to be going across America starting next week, starting in LA, I think, finishing up in New York, I believe. And the tour is called the 88 Mile Per Hour Tour.
Perfect.
Nice. Yes.
I kind of want to see this just because it's going to be up in Philadelphia in about like 3 or 4 weeks. And
is the Pope going to be there?
No, the Pope will not be there. The Pope's long gone.
He definitely
thankfully
wants to see this movie.
Yeah. He's coming back just for this.
The Pope-ocalypse is over.
With this tour, they're actually bringing the original DeLorean with them. There's the guys that's actually covered in the...
they were talking about restoring
it,
right?
And the trailer discussed that. The guys restored the original DeLorean, and now they're touring with this this film. And also, there's a live band performing with them after each showing.
Is it Huey Lewis in the News?
No. They're called the Flux Capacitors.
That's good.
That's fantastic. So...
Hopefully they're good.
Yeah. Apparently they're pretty good.
All
right.
Are they just playing songs from the movie?
Well, a lot of 80s songs, yeah.
Oh,
but, you know, they might do a lot of Huey Lewis, but they probably do a lot of stuff from the 80s as well.
I'm in.
My thoughts on this is, you know, we are quickly approaching the date in which Marty went to the future, which was, I believe, October 21st, 2015. Mm-hmm. So it's coming up in, I think, close to a week.
Cubbies.
Yep, Cubbies. Mm-hmm. Bet on the Cubbies. And
how freaky would that be? Oh my God!
I would love. That's the only reason I'm rooting for the Cubs this year.
It would just be so. It would be so freaky. I'd watch every movie that talked about the future.
Only if it had Michael J. Fox in
it. Well,
yeah.
Well, that was another thing. For a while, people were actually referencing the fact that in Back to the Future 2, they say that they beat a team from Florida, when at the time there was no team from Florida. The Florida Marlins didn't exist in 1991, whenever that film
came
out.
They're the Miami Marlins now.
Yeah, the Miami Marlins now. But then in like 95, 96, the league expanded and they created the Florida Marlins. And everyone's like, oh, well, you know, could this possibly happen? I mean, of course, they're in the National League and that would never happen. But it was like, oh my God, like Back to the Future 2 kind of predicted that there'd be a team from Florida, you know? And then, sure enough, this year, the Cubs are in the playoffs.
Well, it's the weirdest thing is that the Cubs have never won.
Since, like, what, 1908 or something
I don't think the Cubs have ever won a championship.
Never won a World Series?
I don't think they've ever won a championship, dude.
Wow.
I'll double check it, but I know there's
just
a curse.
I thought it had just been, like, a ridiculous amount
like
of time.
Like a drought.
Yeah.
Double check it, man.
Curse of the Billy Goat.
Right.
One of the things that I want to see in this film is the examination of how, you know, Back to the Future has impacted our culture. I mean, just think about, I consider this probably one of the best trilogies of all time, and how it's impacted not just like our culture, but movies in general, you know. And just think about the simplest of concepts, you know, a fish out of water story of a kid that gets displaced in the past and has to, you know, correct things that unfortunately he's fucked up. And it's simple, but it worked so well, you know. And it blows my mind to this day how everything for that first movie was like jerry-rigged, despite the fact that they had Steven Spielberg. You know, they had very little budget for some stuff. And one of the things I love in this documentary that talked about was the fact that Ford offered them $75,000 to make the DeLorean into a Mustang.
Yeah. Yeah.
I had no idea that was actually the case. And thinking about it now, it's like, if the DeLorean had been a Mustang, it wouldn't have nearly as worked. It wouldn't have worked at all.
It wouldn't be as cool, I don't think.
Because the thing about the DeLorean, you know, it's a car that doesn't even...
It's very
like
unique.
A very stupid car.
Yeah, it is. It's a stupid-looking car, but it's now an iconic car. You know, the Mustang was already iconic. It wouldn't have added anything to doesn't the Mustang, you know?
The line, you made a time machine out of a Mustang, doesn't sound quite the same.
No, it does not.
You made a time machine
out of a DeLorean?
Exactly, right? Totally throws off all the iambic pentameter.
No way. Stop.
Now, I know most of us aren't big for documentaries, but what are your guys' thoughts on this one?
I think it looks fun.
Yeah.
I'd see it. I'd watch it.
I love Michael J. Fox, so I'll pretty much see anything he does.
I second that.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. I'd like to see it. I don't know if I would go to the theater to see it.
Okay. See, that's the thing. You were saying that they're going on tour with it, right?
Right.
So does that mean that, like, Michael J. Fox is going around to all the...
who's...
That's on the website. There are a lot of original cast members who are touring with the film.
Because I would love to meet Michael J. Fox.
Oh, I mean, if like it was at a theater, they showed it, and then there was a panel afterwards or something, that would be
pretty
cool.
Yeah.
Oh, you know what? That'll probably happen.
Because I've been to stuff like that, and that's pretty cool.
They could show it at that place in right off 95 in Pennsylvania. It's a place called... It's like right past the stadiums, I think, or right before the stadiums. There's a... It's like Penn Cinema or something. It's like right off 95 when you get into Pennsylvania.
Oh, there's an AMC.
Is that what it is?
I think it's the AMC Painter's Crossing.
Painter's Crossing. Yeah, okay. Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's a pretty cool theater.
Yeah.
Oh, that's the one with the where they serve you.
Yeah. That's what I was just going to ask. Is that the one where
they get a lot of
it's basically it's the
releases.
Draft House, but it's not called a draft house.
And they get a lot of limited releases, so
yes,
it'll be kind of cool
do.
For them to pick it up, and we just have to
that
shoot up 95 to meet Michael J. Fox. I'm
I'd go.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
But I'm,
that would be so cool.
The list I saw online was they have the girl who played Jennifer in the first film. She's touring with them. Not Elizabeth Shue. I know she was in the second and third, but they got the original girl to tour with them. The guy who plays the mayor in the film, but then plays, like, the waiter when he goes back in
Black
time.
Black guy, I don't remember. I
forget his name. He's touring with them. The guy who played George McFly in 2 and 3, he's touring with them.
George is the dad.
Yes. Yeah. Yes.
Wasn't it the same guy who played
No,
George?
It wasn't.
No, the first one was Creepy Thin Man.
Yes.
From
he did not come back for 2 and 3.
Oh. But I guess I didn't pay very close attention.
Well, that's the thing. When you go to the future in 2015, George McFly is hanging upside down, and he has a lot of makeup on. They did that to try and hide the fact that it was a different actor.
Crispin Glover. Mm.
Yeah, that's his name.
Yeah.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. He did not come back.
Also
so
fantastic actor.
They had that whole rig where they suspended him upside down because he had a bad back or something. And
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was a different actor. They have some cast members. I think Christopher Lloyd is showing up for some of the tour dates, but not all of them. Mm-hmm.
That's another dude.
I would love to.
Yeah.
It'd be fun as hell to meet.
Oh, my God. I'm really, really looking forward to this. I hope that it gets a nationwide release. If not, like, nationwide, then, like, a limited, you know, like, it's like Penn or the AMC at Painter's Crossing will pick it up. Because it's a shame if this only hits, like, these particular theaters on these tour dates. Because this is something that I'm sure it'll end up on Netflix or something eventually.
Yeah,
but I would love to see this in a theater, you know, on a big screen.
I'd like to see Back to the Future in theaters on a big screen.
Yeah. Well, awesome. Didn't they do that for the Wilmington Film Festival, didn't they?
Yes, they did.
They showed Back to the Future.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That would be fun.
Yeah.
Yeah, Wilm Film will do that.
I didn't go either because...
No, I'm serious because I had an awful experience.
Yeah, I think it was like the Saturday before you came back or something that when they did that.
Aww.
So,
yeah.
And I wouldn't have gone without you.
Aww. Any final thoughts before we move on?
Like everyone's excited.
I only had one thought. You're fine.
What's that?
The only thought I had was you were saying that it's such an iconic movie with such a simple premise.
Right.
And how do you think it would do if it was released today?
You mean if there had never been a Back to the Future?
Correct.
If that were the case, it would still work. But you have to think about all the other time travel films we've had since Back to the Future.
I think that's what gets you that iconic status is that the fact we have so many movies now that are based on time travel and all this other stuff. But it was pretty
And we had time travel before Back to the Future,
but
it was
like
the first film that was like...
Not on a great scale.
You know, that dealt with it, but wasn't, you know, really, you know... I mean,
this
you can get into the...
fun movie.
You can get into the metaphysics of it with something like Primer, you know, where it really dives into the physics of what you know, time travel is.
No, this was fun physics. I like
right.
Fun.
This is fun physics. Physics. Physics for the kids.
It was Primer, the one where it was like in an like in like a warehouse and there was like a box.
Yes.
And it was.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I liked it, but it's not for everyone. Understandably. Yeah.
So right. Basically, it would probably do fine because the other movies probably would not have existed had that.
More than likely. The only other one we would have gotten would have been like Terminator, you know? Mm. That's probably the only other time travel film that would have made.
That came out in what, 81? 81,
the first one came out in like 81, 82, something like that.
It was somewhere
yeah.
like, I think it was right before Back to the Future. But,
yeah.
I mean, even with Terminator, that's like a completely different.
Right.
Right.
And yeah. that that was a very small aspect of that story. They weren't bouncing back and forth the whole movie.
Sure,
yeah. Right.
Sure. That's a good point.
Moving on to our next trailer, which is Trumbo.
No studio will ever employ a member of the Communist Party.
They have no right to do this. What we're about to do is the one thing everyone says we can. We work.
What's your position on the blacklist?
On it. The blacklist is alive and well, and so is the black market. I'll write you a movie for $1,200.
And you don't want your name on it?
No, you don't want my name on it.
Hey, the man! He's a genius!
Phone for you.
Oh, who is it?
Kirk Douglas.
I'm doing a new picture about one man who tried to take on the whole world. And what's the title? Spartacus.
Holy hell, I'm looking forward to this. I looked up the story behind this film, and I didn't know a whole lot about it, but it's stories like this that almost make me want to become a filmmaker more. You know, it's, you know, striving against all odds, you know, like, and what, you know, certain screenwriters have to work against, like, what they had to do back in the day, you know, just to get their work out because of, you know, just name-calling. We'll get into that in a minute, but directing this, we have Jay Roach. Now, he was the director of the Austin Powers series. He also directed the Meet the Parents series. And he directed The Campaign, which came out in 2012, I believe.
Love that movie.
I never saw The Campaign.
It's Will Ferrell and
Zach Galifianakis. Yeah,
it's fun. Right.
It's fun. It's a good movie, man. It's good.
So he's worked on a lot of comedies, but this is his first real forte into something really dramatic. I mean, there's some comedy in this, too.
Yeah.
But it's admittedly far more serious. In this, we have Bryan Cranston, and who doesn't love Bryan Cranston right now? We have Diane Lane. We have Helen Mirren. We have Louis C.K., we have John Goodman,
yes,
and we have Alan
Tudyk.
Tudyk, yeah.
From Dodgeball, Steve the Pirate.
I love Wash.
Wash,
yeah, he's so
calm.
Good.
Wash,
yeah.
Awesome.
And also
Knight's Tale.
Knight's Tale,
yes.
Tucker and Dale versus Evil.
Oh yes,
yeah.
I love him.
And
he's so good.
I know. Oh my goodness.
I didn't know this. He was King Candy in Wreck-It Ralph.
Nice.
Oh. I have never seen Wreck-It Ralph.
Yeah.
Oh, it's so good.
Yeah, that's a fun movie.
Maybe we should all see it together.
But yeah, he was King Candy.
We should all see it together. I mean, you're just going to watch it
by yourself.
No, I mean,
like you did with all the other things.
No,
I mean, Nightcrawler and How to Train Your Dragon 2. Yeah.
First of all, yes.
All right, then I guess we're going to go see it, and he can go see it by himself.
Okay. Uh-huh.
It was only Nightcrawler, okay?
Uh-huh. How to Train a Dragon 2.
I didn't see that by myself. I saw it with other people.
Not with us. You saw Nightcrawler with not by yourself, too.
That's true.
Yeah, so...
anyway, so
we digress.
So this is based around the life of Dalton Trumbo. Now, he was one of the so-called Hollywood 10. There was 10 screenwriters and producers and filmmakers who were blacklisted back in the late 1940s, I believe, for being supposed communists. Now, for the majority of them, I don't believe it was ever proven that they were communists. It was simply being associated with the Communist Party at the time. It was revealed later that Trumbo had actually been a member of the Communist Party, but had left by the time the allegations had come about. But of course, they asked him, you know, have you been a member of the Communist Party? It was just that stigma. It was that, you know, that red fear that was just starting up in the late 1940s. Yeah, I'm sorry, the Red Scare. Yeah, that was just starting up then. And the idea of, oh, well, you work in one of the biggest industries in America and your ideas are being posted for millions to watch. We're not going to let you work. And, you know, despite the fact that, you know, you want to, you know, label them communists or whatever, you still have the freedom of speech in America, but they're saying, no, you don't have that right now. You cannot, you know, put your message out there. You cannot work. And what they had to go through to just make a simple living, you know, and what they're basically working on the black market, creating a black market for screenplays, which seems ridiculous. But then when you think back to like the writer's strike of 2009, we almost had something similar to that, you know, when the writers tried to make a living, but they didn't want to give into the demands of the studios. So there was almost the same thing happening for a while, but for entirely different reasons. But as far as the movie's concerned, what do you guys think about this? I mean, and understand this is, you know, we're coming up to Oscar season. I could easily call this Oscar bait. In fact, I will call it Oscar bait.
But we don't care when you use that term. So, I know. You know, don't even worry about that. It looks great. The cast looks great.
Yes.
I'm very, very excited to see how they treat the subject matter just because it's really interesting.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm super excited about this.
Right. And this is something that the Academy will eat up. Anything that deals with, like the artist.
Deals with the
so
Academy.
They're just extremely narcissistic.
Yeah, anything that deals with the Academy.
But unfortunately, that's the truth. I mean, think about The Artist, you know, which was a silent film that dealt with changing from the silent era, you know? Mm-hmm. That's why it was heralded by the Academy. Something like Argo, which dealt, again, with a film and you know, like a fake film in the industry. And now you have this, which deals about screenwriting. This is something that the Academy will eat up. But even so, I think it looks fantastic.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, just like Argo was really good, despite the fact that it's, you know, had a lot of factual inaccuracies.
Yes, it did.
Mm. But
I have a feeling this is probably going to be the same way.
Yeah. but it was still a really, really fun movie to watch.
And also had John Goodman.
It did.
Because Argo, fuck yourself.
Yes. Nice.
Wow.
I love that movie.
It it's so good. It's so I love fun. Argo so much.
It was definitely a fun movie. Canadians don't like it very much, but it was
true,
a good movie.
Very true.
and understandably.
Right.
but yeah, no, this looks really good. And I do have to disagree with you though. I don't think that you can necessarily relate it back to the writer's strike.
I know what you're saying. I mean, I was talking about just the black market of screenplays, okay. Not necessarily why it occurred. No.
Yeah. But either way, it looks really good, and I think it has a really strong story behind it, and it looks fun. It looks interesting.
Agreed. Black Lantern, Goddess.
Power cast, man.
Yeah.
This is what I call power cast.
Definitely. We've got
awesome
a couple
people.
Of them this week. Yeah. There's another one coming up. We'll
awesome
talk about.
People who you would never think would work together. And like they're pulling people out of left field, man. Like Alan Tudyk and Adewale, who's been in everything ever.
Oh, yeah. He's playing a small part in this. I forgot about
man.
That.
It's like these are some awesome actors.
The guy's name who I held a time trying to pronounce.
Adewale Akinnuye.
Abinje. Yeah.
Agbaje, yeah.
Yes.
Louis C.K. Like, it's ridiculous, dude. There's so many good people in this movie. There's no way.
And you were talking the same thing about, I know you weren't here to discuss it, but Steve Jobs that recently came out.
Yeah, the cast. Ridiculous.
You loved that cast, but you said you wanted it with any other film.
Any other film. That was my thing. I wasn't here that week, but I was like, man, it was... I think Dystopian was with me on that one, right?
Yeah.
It's like, okay, for the 37th time, we're going to do a Steve Jobs movie, and we're going to... put in this freaking power cast and we're gonna do the same movie again.
Yeah, like it looks good. It looks good, but I don't care.
Yeah, but I don't fucking care anymore. Like I want them to do something else.
Right.
Do something. I don't even give a shit if you do it like Mark Zuckerberg. Well, they already did Mark Zuckerberg too.
Right.
Like I don't give a fuck. Pick somebody else. Bill Gates.
I was about to say if it had been Bill Gates, would you felt
because then it would have been a different subject matter.
Okay.
It'd be terrific.
Fair enough.
Power casts are awesome, man. I love that kind of stuff. So this looks cool.
Nice. Yeah. Goddess?
It looks interesting. I don't know.
Yeah,
I don't know what else to say.
I mean, is it? Do you want a little bit more to it? Like, do you want like a little more action, like Argo would have had, or do you want?
No, not necessarily.
You want some more action?
Definitely.
Giggity goo.
I don't know. Like, I can't say there's anything wrong with the trailer. I don't know. I mean, it looks fun, but I don't think I'm in love with it.
Okay.
I don't know.
That's fine. Like, that's fine.
Fair.
And I think I agree with you in the sense that, especially with the trailers that we have this week, I think the other one that we're going to talk about later with the, you know, with the other power cast, mm-hmm. I think I'm much more interested in that
one. Yeah.
So, but we'll get to that.
Yes, we will get to that.
But yeah, so super excited yeah, for that.
You don't
one.
Have to raise your hand. Black
Interjection. Power cast is now a thing.
Yeah, I know. Would you start it?
With the power cast.
It's a good day.
Moving on from that, we have The Good Dinosaur.
We need to get home.
I got a job for you. Keep on the dodge and sidle up the loblolly past them horn heads.
What?
That creature protected you.
What is his name?
I don't know.
I name him, I keep him. Killer.
Stinky!
Violet.
Spike!
Lunatic!
Spot! Spot! Come here, Spot, come here!
Well, ain't you just the cutest thing?
I'm done being scared.
If you ain't scared, you ain't alive.
It looks absolutely adorable. Pixar, damn it, you... You've gone back to your roots, and I love it.
We're all going to see it. Next trailer.
No. I've said it before. I'm glad that Pixar is finally getting back to doing original stories. I mean, I know they have a couple sequels coming out soon. They've got Cars 3. They've got...
Did I see a Wreck-It too? Ralph 2?
Well, that's not Pixar. That's okay. Disney Animation.
Oh, my fault. Right?
That's okay. But everything's digital now, so it's easy to get them confused. Yeah. But we've got Cars 3, we've got Finding Dory, and we have
Incredibles
2. Right. Of those, I'm looking forward to Finding Dory and Incredibles 2.
Incredibles 2 will probably be good.
Yes.
It'll probably be incredible. Yeah. Anybody use that joke yet? I'll see myself out.
No, you won't.
But
no, you won't. Starts punching his fist. I can't do that.
Starting off, we have Peter Schoen for the director for this. He was a story artist for numerous Pixar films. He's worked on a lot with that studio, but he's only directed one short, which is Partly Cloudy. I forget what movie that was attached to. It might have been Up. So this is his directorial debut. In this, we have Sam Elliott. Now, you know me.
What now?
You may know Sam Elliott as the Stranger from The Big Lebowski, but he's been in a lot of things.
He was in Ghost Rider.
Yes, he was in Ghost Rider.
Oh, I thought that was going to be terrible.
I mean, he
for
has
everybody.
A very, very recognizable voice.
Thank you for smoking.
Yeah, thank you for smoking. Good he was in a Golden Compass.
Oh, this guy.
Yeah.
No, he's other Ron.
He was in Justified.
Yeah, it was in Justified.
Without his mustache, he looks terrifying.
Yes, I think I prefer him with the mustache.
Which, yes, with the mustache is much better.
There was no other Ron.
Other Ron in Parks and Rec. Yeah.
A-Ron?
No.
A-Ron?
No.
We also have Anna Paquin. We have Jeffrey Wright. And we have Frances McDormand,
mm-hmm.
Who you know from Fargo and Almost Famous. A
and
lot
maybe,
of
and
Coen
maybe something
films.
Else that's coming out.
Yes,
who knows?
Maybe.
You also have Alan Tudyk.
Oh, yeah.
In this movie?
Mm-hmm.
Oh!
That's what we were laughing about earlier. You're like, oh, my God.
It's in everything.
So everything. Hot right now.
Well, that's the thing. He's getting a lot of work as a voice actor now. I didn't know that.
Who, Alan Tudyk?
Yeah. I mean, good for him. And I think he's a funny guy. More work for him. But the animation in this is beautiful.
It's different.
It is. It's not...
Not in a bad way.
I mean, the opening shot we see of the dinosaurs is pretty, like, realistic dinosaurs, like, mm-hmm. before the asteroid hits. But then, shortly after that, when we see the dinosaurs talking, they look admittedly a lot more... animated.
Yeah, I was going to say kind of Land Before Time-ish.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Like, but
that's
updated.
That's what I was about to say. I was going to say Littlefoot.
They're updated classic characters.
Right.
It looks great.
Also, the story is kind of like Land Before Time. Yeah. I mean, the Brontosaurus, Brachiosaurus, I forget what it's called, loses a parental figure, sorry to say, and then has to go on a journey to find the rest of...
It happened in literally every animal movie.
Right. Then has to go on a journey to find the rest of his family. Now, in Land Before Time, obviously, it's a big group of dinosaurs that are going on this journey. But in this, it's just him and a random human.
They don't necessarily not find anybody else on the way, though.
Oh, well, yeah, they, you see that. That, was it Sam Elliott's character? He has, like, a pack of T-Rexes, and they kind of adopt the Brachiosaurus, which, okay.
They're fattening him up.
They're farming him.
Winter's coming.
That's right.
Hi-oh. Can I hang with you? They bring the human, the human's called Spot, right? Then calling him Spot.
Yeah. In
the
they ended up a dog.
Yeah, he's basically a dog, which I think is pretty funny. A couple things I want to mention about this trailer. One, the first thing I'm going to say is, I'm a little afraid that, and this is going to sound idiotic, that this is going to be used by creationists to show that, oh, look, this is how it actually happened.
What?
You're thinking so far outside the box.
You're afraid of this?
You're in a different box.
That's the most irrational fear I've heard in my life.
I know, that's stupid. But like,
wait, why would they say, why would that be, what?
Okay.
What would the,
yeah, all of that. Answer her. Okay. Answer the question.
I understand that creationist arguments are idiotic. They really are. But they're trying to find any foot to stand on to make arguments for their claims and to like get more funding or whatever and get more kids to believe what they believe. Here's a Pixar film that has a human alongside dinosaurs, and they say, look, here's how it happened, kids.
But it's but also saying if the asteroid never hit the Earth, so it has no
I got ground. That. And true,
they'll
true.
They'll just cut that part out and then just be like...
That big if in the beginning there.
Right. You get what I'm saying. This is a film obviously more geared towards kids than adults.
Wait, but don't creationists also claim that dinosaurs never existed in the first place?
Yeah, fossils are put there by the devil
exactly.
to
leave you. No, well,
and Kathy Bates.
Yes and no.
Some the devil.
Of course she is. Haven't you seen Misery?
Misery and what was that other terrible movie about Schmidt?
Oh god.
Where she got in the hot tub. Sorry.
There's
digressing.
Several different kinds of creationists. Oh. There are some who say that, oh well, the carbon dating and the fossil record is true, but God created it billions of years ago. There are some who say that the fossil record is wrong, but dinosaurs did exist.
Yeah,
then
God
there are some who say that dinosaurs
jobs.
Never existed, and they're put there by the devil to test our faith.
Okay, so if we're going to go with the dinosaurs were there, and then, you know, there were humans or whatever, but this is... That doesn't make... there is no way that they can make that argument regardless.
Are you okay?
Here's the thing.
Burning up.
If people make any kind of argument like that, it's not even going to be on a blip on my radar.
No. Just go away.
It's really not. It's not even worth my breath to discuss this because who gives a shit? Who gives a shit?
He does.
I know.
I give a
who?
Shit.
Who?
I give a shit because they have museums for this shit and they're going to get more kids to believe it.
Listen, man, if you want to get upset about what dumb people are doing with their dumb lives, it's up
but
to
also,
you, but who gives a shit, man?
You can't actually... Okay, from what we have seen in the trailer... You can't actually say that evolution did not exist and did not coincide in the parallel timeline with the dinosaurs as well. Because, like, they're just saying that if the meteor did not hit the Earth, right? So this could be still a couple million years later where,
true,
you know, where
true.
Evolution had already occurred.
And that's why the dinosaurs look different.
Or something,
yeah.
right? Like, they're
and speak
or talk
American,
I was gonna say,
American,
or talking.
American
talking,
English.
Yeah. Whereas, you know, I mean, there's you can't like
stop this train. I want to get off.
Yes.
Like,
what
yeah,
is going on?
There is. I don't think that this is a legitimate fear that we need to have right now.
No.
I think people might try to say it, but it's just so stupid. No one's gonna listen.
Exactly.
I want Mike
right.
to be able to say, "I told you so," though. I do want that pretty bad.
Yeah,
after this discussion.
You send me one article about a creationist flipping this shit, I'm printing it out and making you eat it. Do you understand me? Do you understand? That's not a threat, that's a promise.
Because I actually predicted it?
That's right.
No, it's going to happen, and you know it's going to happen.
Of course.
But it doesn't mean that we have to actually pay attention to any
that's
of it.
That's right.
Yeah. They're just gonna be trolls, man.
Yeah, yes. Just like any other
let them be
stupid
under their
shit
bridge.
That happens on
shit?
The internet. We can't ignore it.
Yeah, and it's yes. better to ignore it.
Yes.
Okay.
You will live longer.
All right. Yeah. And getting off of that, what are your guys' thoughts on this trailer?
I don't care.
You don't care? What are you talking about?
Good.
Which horror movie are we in? That was the most terrifying sound I've ever heard in my life.
That's pretty scary.
Your voice echoed.
Dude, this looks fantastic.
Listen, you. This is my opinion, and I've told you it. You're going to have... I really don't.
It's true. There's a big hole there.
Yeah, that's true.
I can see it.
Bleeding out. This shirt used to be white.
So the dystopian's dead.
But Fangirl, you said you were getting quite emotional.
Like, it doesn't look bad. Hold on. It doesn't look bad. I'm not saying it's a
you
piece
hate
of
it.
Shit.
You despise it.
I'm going to hurt you.
That's essentially look, what he's saying.
I'm going to hurt you next. It doesn't look bad.
Do you dare try?
Well, yeah. I mean, it'll hurt me too, but I'm going to... I'm a trier, okay? That's just who I am.
I'm a trier.
You're like Rocky.
That's true. He was a trier. Everyone's been saying that for years.
I can't eat another drink.
Hook me up.
I'm not saying it's bad. It's just I don't want to see it.
Actually, no.
I don't really... I'm not going to go out of my way to see it.
Two ginger beers in the freezer. Can you
You're whispering it directly into the microphone.
You just put your mic closer to say that. That was excellent.
That's what I did. I was like, hook me up, and I brought the microphone
Excuse me,
closer.
Ma'am. Excuse me. Excuse me.
This may be one of those movies where... My wife says, let's go see a movie. And I'll be like, oh, there's that dinosaur movie that's out. You want to see that? Because it's Pixar, and everybody loves Pixar. So it'll be like a date night movie. Yeah. I'd see it in theaters.
Yeah.
Okay. Fangirl, what do you think?
I mean, when I saw the trailer, I was like crying by the end of it.
Schindler's
I have
List.
Problems.
Did you just say Schindler's List?
He yes, did.
Did you cry at the end of the Schindler's List trailer, too?
Thank you.
I don't think.
You're such a goddess.
Aww.
Of gore just breaks it over your head.
Dead. Oh my god, you were so awesome.
Gore.
So I don't know if I'm going to see it.
Because you don't want to be heartbroken.
Yes, essentially.
You'll
mean,
see it.
I'd
rather cry in private at home than in a theater.
Yeah, that's probably. I'm Bring probably gonna have to watch it at home.
You can already tell it's gonna be like Lion King. The first 10 minutes, you're gonna be like,
yeah.
He's gonna be like, Dad.
Oh,
he's gonna have to eat.
You're gonna make her cry.
He's gonna have to eat his dad just to survive.
They're dinosaurs, man. They're brutal.
That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying.
He got washed. No, he.
No, he'll find him later, washed up and kind of bloated and stuff.
He's a huge dinosaur.
Oh my god.
How do you not find him later?
Jesus.
But,
is that cannibalism or like?
Yes.
No, his dad will be dead, but he'll have to eat the human.
Oh, that kid's like an afternoon snack.
That's fair enough.
See,
he's a dinosaur. Yeah.
It's like me eating an Oreo.
Right.
I'm like, where's the rest?
Why is it called the Good Dinosaur?
Yeah,
I don't get the title.
Did he seem bad to you?
Yes, evil.
How?
That smirk on his face obviously meant that something else was going on inside of his head.
Seemed like a good dinosaur to me.
He's already eaten people by the beginning of this film.
He actually pushed his dad into the flood.
That's true.
To kill
That's true.
Him.
Wait,
Shyamalan twist.
You're going to be delicious.
Wait, so but we're still calling him the Good Dinosaur? I don't get it.
That's why I'm wondering why it's good.
It's
because he's obviously so bad.
You'll have to see the movie then, won't you?
Yep.
Okay.
In summary, I'm looking forward to this. I don't know. I know the dystopian doesn't have a heart and won't see it.
That's true.
I think you got 3 or 4 of us here.
Yeah, I think everyone else is looking forward to it.
I think 4 of us.
Yeah.
I'm like on the edge. I'm like, I'll see it. But then if I like miss it in theaters, I won't be sad.
Yeah,
I'll see
me
it on
too.
TV.
I
think I'm waiting for it to come out on Netflix just simply because, again, I don't want to have people think that I'm having an asthma attack in the theater. That has happened before.
How about that asthma?
Because I hyperventilate so much while I'm crying.
Yeah. People like call the paramedics or something.
No, just my friends just look at me and be like, "Oh my god, are you okay?"
Oh. But you meant like people around you, like people you don't know.
Right.
No, that's in theater. This happened.
Is there a doctor in the theater?
This happened when I was in Hong Kong. They don't really care about other people. So
oh, okay.
Well, all right.
Moving on.
So. Moving on to our next trailer, which is The Forest.
Your sister went into Aokigahara Forest. It's where lost people go to commit suicide.
What? I'm coming, Jess.
I'm looking for my sister.
She went into forest. I want to hire a guide.
No guide. Forest is very dangerous.
spirits cannot rest there. They come back. Angry.
So, this film is directed by Jason Zada. Now, he was the writer for The Houses October Built, which is a film that the goddess and I saw. Now, I wasn't a huge fan of that.
Did he write the first half or the last half?
I think he wrote the whole thing.
Oh, okay.
The Houses October Built was a horror film that came out last year. We actually discussed it on here. It was about a group of filmmakers going around to haunted attractions trying to find the most extreme one.
Did they go to Jason's Woods?
No, they would be highly extreme. Disappointed by that.
They probably edited that part out because they waited for 12 hours. Sorry, Jason.
But I was kind of disappointed by it. Goddess, you didn't hate it as much as I did.
I liked everything but the end.
The ending was very disappointing.
So like Blair Witch.
You know, you're not far off from that.
Yeah.
But this is his directorial debut. In this, we have Natalie Dormer, of course, from Game of Thrones.
In everything
right now. Right?
Literally everything.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, okay, yeah.
We also have Taylor Kinney.
Woohoo! I like that guy.
Yeah, he's from Zero Dark Thirty, and what else has he been in?
He was in, what was that movie called? Where I was like, damn, that guy's just really good looking, and it pisses me off.
Huh.
Hold on, I'm on it. Keep talking.
Okay, just had a sip of the dark and stormy. Thank you to Zestopian for giving me that recipe.
Yes, good.
It's good for Halloween time.
Good all the time.
Ah, yes. But this is based around the tales of...
The Other Woman. Sorry, that's lame.
Oh.
The Other Woman?
Is that what he was in? It's based around the tales
on
of
with
the Other
board,
Woman.
Now, this is based on the tales of... I'm going to have a hard time pronouncing this name.
That's a weird name.
Aokigahara Forest.
Well, okay.
That sounds good.
Yeah.
We believe you.
Okay. Right on. But this is also known as the Suicide... Oh, sorry. What were you saying,
yeah,
Goddess?
Suicide Forest.
The Suicide Forest.
The other name.
And
mentioned that, right?
The Sea of Trees. Yeah. I hadn't heard about this until I discovered this film.
Really? I've heard about this.
Really?
Mm-hmm. I have no desire to go there.
It was on Destination Truth.
Really?
I think that's probably where I first heard about it.
It's on TLC.
No idea where I heard it
wrong.
From.
Wrong. It was on Sci-Fi.
Yeah.
Now,
Josh Gates. He's awesome.
There's no official statistics to this, but as of 2004, an average of 100 people commit suicide in this forest every year.
Yeah.
Now, up until...
Or they go in and they go missing.
I'm sorry, what do you mean there's no official statistics?
Because
like, somebody
know
was just
how
like,
many...
hey, did you know there's 100 people that kill themselves in this forest every year?
Well, the
Jeff... Thanks, Jeff. Jeff just walks away.
That sounds like a good number. 100.
Like
no, they don't know how many people actually go in.
Is this
the
from
woods.
The Census Bureau? Or?
Well, they go by how many bodies they discover.
Fair enough.
As well as
that's
how many people have gone
for.
Missing in the country. You know, and they whether or not, you know, they follow up and say, you know, oh, well, were they suicidal, this and that.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the numbers have been going up, and by 2010, the Japanese government stopped publishing the numbers. They were trying to basically stop giving publicity to this forest because people around the world were visiting it.
Just like everything else in the world.
Right.
Like, don't give it publicity.
Right. And there's like, look, we're going to stop talking about this. But as of this point, the highest numbers they have...
I know, that's what I was about to say. I was like...
The low estimates for each year are around, like, 50. High numbers are around 200 per year now. And I just actually saw a short film earlier today when I had a... last night. There was a short film put out by Vice, which discusses this forest. And, like, there's a guy who works with the Environmental Service, and... He's at the base of Mount Fuji, I believe.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. He's with the environmental group doing surveying, a geologist. But they actually recruited him to say, look, you're going to go out into this area. We want you to be like a suicide prevention agent. Like, so he walks through this area where he's supposed to be like doing surveys. And if he sees someone, he's trained to like talk them out of it. And it's like, and in this documentary, they actually find a guy camped in the woods. And it's like, oh my God. Like, the guy says, oh, I'm not out here to do that. I'm just here to camp and see the woods. And the guy's like, you're bullshitting me.
You liar.
Yeah, no one comes
why
out
this
here.
This particular woods.
No one comes out here to just camp, you know? But he did say, when people go out there to camp, they're usually debating it, but they don't know whether or not they're going to do it. So they might go out there for several nights to determine whether or not they were going to do this or not. So they do find tents out there. But yeah, going into this, I looked up that documentary, that little short film, because I never heard of this before. This is freaky as fuck. I mean, I'm just saying, like, this, the story of this is mortifying.
I'm impressed, actually.
It's, impressed?
It's impressed by the story. It's unique.
Mm-hmm. I mean, yeah, I can't think of anywhere else in the world where something like this happens. I mean, I haven't done any looking, but I don't think of anywhere else where people just go to a particular location just to kill themselves.
Think of most popular bridges, unfortunately, in the world.
Well, true, but at the same time, I don't think the Golden Gate is getting 100 a year.
No, but it's still, those are the places.
That bridge is pretty. Right. This forest is creepy.
Yeah.
Right. But yeah, the basis of this film is that you have Natalie Dormer, who is a identical twin, I believe, right?
Yes.
And, yeah. She discovers that her sister has gone to this forest. And of course, as identical twins apparently do, they have this really special connection, this apparently psychic connection that they show. Right. Yep. So she goes into this forest and finds a tent for her sister and says, I'm not leaving without her, and then insert horrific, creepy
all
shit.
All hell breaks
loose. Yeah, all hell breaks loose.
Was this the same thing where this is going to sound creepy, I don't mean it like that, but like, was this the same trailer, I'm trying to remember, with where she was in the shower?
Yes.
And there was, okay, that's
yeah,
what I was...
Yeah, a figure comes in, yeah.
Yeah, because I was like, whoa, that dude appeared real quick. Like, yeah. He's all of a sudden just like right at the door.
Now, this kind of hits on some of the same notes that like the remake of Ju-on did, The Grudge.
Yeah.
Where it's, you know, the Westerner going to Japan and experiencing their horror.
Sarah
you know?
Michelle
yeah, mm-hmm. Sarah Michelle Gellar, yes. Yeah. Now, I liked the remake of The Grudge. I thought it was decent. You didn't like it?
Stupid.
You didn't like it?
I did not like it.
Did you like the original?
I did not see the original.
Ah.
I was surprised that you watched the remake.
Right.
A form of basis.
Confucius 2.0 made me watch it.
Ah.
It was a trade-off. If I watched that, he was going to watch The Sound of Music.
And he still hasn't
And he still hasn't
yet.
Seen it. Oh.
Yeah,
oh.
We need to make that happen.
That's a good man right there. You should marry him.
Cold-blooded.
Darkness.
Darkness. I'm looking forward to this. I mean, not just because it's, you know, a horror film. I look forward to almost all horror films. This is a story that, again, I don't know a whole lot about a real location that I'm interested in hearing more about. I mean, it's morbid curiosity, but I still want to, you know, discover more about this place and its history. You know, and they don't know how far back this goes. They say it's just as recent as the last century, but people who live in the area said, oh, no, this has been going on for a millennia now. People going into this forest and doing this. Mm-hmm. And some say, you know, some would do it for seppuku, some would do it for honor, but others would just do it because they were tired of society. And in this little short film I saw, they said that it more often than not, the people going in and doing it are people who can't adjust to modern day society, apparently. And that's like apparently the theme of this place, the people who just hate society. And while I can sympathize with them, it's like, you know what? What was that?
Oh, I thought I asked her a question.
No, you...
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Just remember last night when you insulted.
I didn't insult your hand.
Kinda.
What do you mean?
Remember that little crack you made last night?
Uh-oh.
When Janelle walked away?
I didn't make a crack to make a pun. I didn't make a crack about your hand. I said that... I said that she was learning from you, so obviously she picked up your tendencies on...
As I lay there with a lay there with a broken hand.
You're
my broken hand.
In the middle of the bowling alley.
I thought you were there for that. The Will?
I think he was bowling.
Yeah, I don't know what you guys are talking about.
Janelle had a bad last game.
Uh-huh.
Well, not bad. It was a little lower than her average.
You can say something and then stand by it. It's okay.
No, but it wasn't that bad.
It was bad.
No. Okay. Well, anyway.
Like, we're all allowed to have bad games. Okay. It's okay.
I disagree.
Well, she was a little upset, and, you know, and Danny was saying that, you know, he's trying to keep her calm, and I said, well, you know, she is married to you.
No. What you said was, she came back, and she was disappointed. She kind of put her head down, and then she went and stood up and, like, walked away to do whatever women do. And I was like, huh. I don't get it, man. I don't know why she's so depressed. Like, cheer up. She was like, well, she did learn from the best. And I'm like, sitting here with a broken hand.
Yeah, so what? He said something really apt and true. What's the big deal?
Leave this weird, dry feeling in my mouth.
That's true. That's true, I do.
Every time.
Can you giggity you yourself?
Yeah,
I know.
Yeah, why not? I don't
know. Can you giggity yourself?
Giggity on that, by the way.
That's a different podcast.
Oh, God. Oh.
But I digress.
Ah, drink.
Drink.
No, that's all right. Yeah, sorry about that.
They like it.
Yeah. But as far as this film is concerned, as far as
drink.
This film,
drink.
Drink.
I get to make that noise. I don't know where that came from.
My favorite thing ever. Oh! She fucking cheered. It was awesome.
Oh, shit.
We're writing down the rules for this drinking nice. Game.
No, I think we
oh
all know
God,
the rules.
We're only on the third trailer. This is great.
No, we're on the fourth.
Fourth trailer. This is great.
As far as this is concerned, yes, I'm very much looking forward to it. Its release date has me concerned. It is a horror film in January, which tend to really, really be bad.
So is The Witch.
The Witch. Oh, The Witch. Yeah. Well, that's because it keeps getting delayed. That's not the fault of the
sure
film.
I was pretty sure there was an ellipsis at the end of that.
Yeah.
I was waiting. I was like, The Witch.
Where Witch?
The Where... Their witch.
Their castle.
Nice.
Regardless of that, I am very much looking forward to this film. Anyone else?
Looks interesting. I mean, it looks comparable to like The Grudge or that kind, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I liked how it was shot.
Yes.
All the scenes with the forest, that was pretty cool.
Mm-hmm. I like, you know, I'm very used to American horror and seeing, you know, how ghosts look in our eyes and in American cinema. Obviously, this is an American film, but it's going to dive more into what, you know, what other cultures see as horror, you know, like what their demons are in that forest and how they look, you know, or their ghosts. But,
not
what, you disagree?
Yeah, I do disagree. I mean, considering you're saying that it is an American film, isn't it more of an American interpretation of what other cultures...
Yes, but so was The Grudge to that effect.
But that's still not necessarily the other... I mean, like, do you know what I'm trying to say? Like,
yeah,
I think I know what you're saying, because it's not a remake. It didn't initiate anywhere, but the fact that it takes place somewhere else is the fact that you got American people trying to
understand
what they are going through,
okay,
seeing.
Okay, yes, which is why I do like foreign horror films more, because we get to see their interpretations of horror. But that being said, I would hope that these filmmakers are taking from this location, this culture, and are, you know, trying to do their best to replicate how, you know, horrific.
And not just,
you know, fucking... Not just say, oh, let's just put an American ghost in
what's
Japan,
the word,
you know? Wait,
not sodomizing is actually a good word. Whoa. For what sometimes they do. But, I mean,
are we talking about ghosts?
Yeah. No. What American
ghost
filmmakers
ghost sodomy?
Do,
what the hell has just happened?
What American filmmakers
nope,
do
I'm out.
To...
I know what you're saying.
Yeah, I understand what you mean.
You know, they just kind of destroy them because they're just like, I want money.
Right.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
No, it doesn't seem like that because it's not a remake.
No, it's an original story.
Thing.
Now, there have been films about this forest before. There have been.
Okay,
but
that's
not,
what I was
wondering.
I was like, man, I haven't heard about this
but
before.
But not like this. They've usually been documentaries or dramas.
So nothing on the big screen trying to, really get into what's...
Yeah. Right.
Like, and I feel like, you know, being on this podcast specifically, because you guys are such horror fans, and I'm not, and I don't usually get a lot of exposure to that, I realized a pattern in terms of what I'm looking for in horror. Not that I'm ever going to see any of it, but I would like it if they delved more into the lore.
Right.
I don't like it so much. As you said, like, if there are jump scares and stuff like that, that's not something that necessarily interests me.
Mm-hmm.
But it's, you know, it's the idea of planting something, you know, planting a seed at the back of your mind, and that is the thing that scares me, and that's the kind of thing that I like in horror. And with something like this, there's so much rich history and so much kind of just storytelling behind it, and I feel like that is what they should be focusing on more than, you know, the jump scares and stuff like that.
All right, I understand that. That's fair.
And there, you know, from that, I loved your explanation, by the way. Your whole, that was perfect. But they're Americanizing it, whether you want to say it or not, because they're focused on one American girl who lost an American girl, and her American friend is helping her through.
That's
the,
true.
The
and
woods.
They were
it's
reading.
Like,
that's very true.
She was American girl.
It's like, so no matter how you look at it, I see what you're saying. I think it's gonna have that American twist to it. So, yeah.
You say you're not exposed to much horror, but this coming week you will be exposed to some horror. But we'll get to that later.
Giggity.
We'll get to that later. Okay. Moving on to our next trailer. Oh, I'm sorry. Yes, Goddess.
Fuck it.
No!
Now you heard her. Fuck it. Move on.
Go. I'm not gonna forget it. You're the goddess of gore. I'm not going to skip.
Oh, wait, hold on. I got this. Goddess, would you like to say something?
I would really like to hear what you have to say.
Please.
There are at least three people in this room who would like to hear what you have to say.
I'm indifferent.
There are at least two people in this room who would like to hear what you have to say.
Three. I changed my mind.
All right.
Okay, stop flip-flopping.
There's two and a half people who would like to hear what you have to say.
Okay, so yes, I've heard about this, the forest there and everything, and I think it's really, really interesting, but they don't really know, like, why all of these people are going there to do this, so I think that's super interesting, but I don't know, I'm afraid with this movie, with the trailer that you see and everything that happens, it's more, I'm just afraid that it's just gonna be, like, every other movie.
Yeah. Which is like what I mean by
Getting
into that story, into like the heart of it.
I think it has the potential.
Potential. Yeah. You're right.
Boil them, bash them, stick them in a stew.
Boil them, mash them, stick them in a stew.
Potatoes. But I just don't think that with this story that they're going with, I don't think that it's going to be as good as I want it to be.
Okay.
Yeah. You look like you wanted to say something dystopian.
I know where you're coming from with that. The concept of the forest is more interesting than the actual story that they're going to tell.
Yes.
At least in my mind.
Yeah.
I'd like... You shut up, phone. I'd rather...
My phone or you?
I'll chuck it. I'll get $100 on MTV in the 90s or whenever that was. I'd rather see a documentary about the forest more than this movie.
Like a legit one, not like an in-depth documentary. Did you see what happened? Not like a television type
of course
thing.
Yes.
The one thing I'll leave mine at this. The one thing I liked about this film is that it says that everybody commits suicide here and that everybody turns into ghosts. They didn't look like ghosts to me.
No, they did not.
Not a one thing in that film looked like a ghost. In the trailer. Was the hand in the tent. It's the only thing that slightly resembled a ghost. Mm-hmm. Everything else kind of looked like a zombie.
Yeah. Or a mummy.
Here's the thing. That might be just a difference in Eastern versus Western.
And that's what gets me a little more interested. Is like, this isn't your typical every horror movie that's coming out right now ghost.
Yeah. Right. And that was my point I was driving
at earlier. Literally every horror movie that comes out right now is like about ghosts.
And I understand that, you know, the idea of, you think that, or we think that it might possibly be a different interpretation. But again, I still think that it is an American interpretation of.
It's always going to be.
Right. Of course, and it's not hiding that. So I think.
And that's fair. You know.
That's why it's all American actors.
Yes.
Right.
Well, Natalie Dormer is an American, is she?
No, she's.
I'm sorry, that's not what I mean.
Like all Western kind
of. Western, yeah. Okay. That's what I should have said. Sorry about that.
We'll fix it in post, man. Don't worry.
Moving on to our next trailer, we have Hail Caesar.
Mr. Mannix.
What's up?
The director can't find Baird Whitlock.
Somebody slipped it under my door. We have your movie star. Gather $100,000 and await instructions. Who are we? The future. Hello, Bert.
Hello, Mr. Mannix.
Lawrence, Obie, thank you all for coming. The studio needs your help. Baird Whitlock has been kidnapped.
This is bad. Bad for movie stars everywhere. She sings the
perfect harmony. Let's spend 24 hours. But we're looking for him. We don't want it in the gossip columns.
This is going to cost the studio a lot of money.
And that's where you come in. I need some cash.
You must have very strong forearms. Is it hard squeezing it like that?
It's part of the job, miss.
Directing this, we have the Coen brothers. And
yes!
Yes. Woo-hoo! Of course, yes. Who doesn't fucking love the Coen brothers?
Communists.
List off a few. Fargo. Raising Arizona. Burn After Reading.
That was so good.
No Country for Old Men. Yes. I know I'm missing more, but, I mean, God, they are...
It's going to be that awesome.
I know. It's going to be so much fun. In this, I'm... Powercast.
Powercast. See, that's what I wanted to come back and say. I wanted to be like, did anybody say Powercast yet?
No. So we have Josh Brolin, George Clooney, Ralph Fiennes, Jonah Hill.
Ralph Fiennes.
It says Ralph Fiennes.
Yes, but it's pronounced Rafe.
It's sorry.
Pronounced.
Sorry.
Say R. Fiennes.
R. Fiennes.
R. L. Fiennes.
Yeah. Jonah Hill.
Loose
Scarlett
Pulse.
Johansson. Frances McDormand. As now every Coen Brothers film.
Of course.
Tilda Swinton. Yes. Channing Tatum. Clancy Brown. And oddly enough, Dolph Lundgren.
There we go.
We didn't see him in the trailer, I don't
winner,
think.
Winner,
winner. So, this concept was first thought up by the Coen Brothers in 2004, but they shelved it until, like, last year. They were like, they liked the idea, but they were having a lot of troubles with the screenplay. And then finally, like, last year, like, okay, let's try and work on this again. And the original story was that it was going to take place in the 1920s, set to a stage play called Hail Caesar. Then they changed it around a little bit and said, oh, well, now it's going to be the 1940s or 50s, and it's going to be a movie, and that's going to be called Hail Caesar.
It looks freaking hilarious.
Oh, my God. I think they chose
the right era
Do that. Yes. Like, so the concept of this film is that you have Josh Brolin, who is called a fixer, I believe. I believe that's the term they use in the trailer, and that it's a Hollywood term, I believe.
Kind of like Harvey Keitel in Pulp Fiction.
You see,
he just kind of steps in
exactly
and remedies things.
And that's what he is in this movie, except for cinema. And at one point, the character of George Clooney, who is apparently a well-known actor in the industry, is kidnapped by a bunch of people who are called the Future, whatever, like, the Future is calling, yeah, which is a little odd. At that point, they say, you have to pay us $100,000 or you're not going to get your actor back. So he recruits Channing Tatum and a few of the smaller actors in his studio to go out and say, oh, well, you have to rescue this bigger actor. This looks amazing. I'm just saying, just that premise alone is hilarious, and I cannot wait for this. It reminds me of, like, there's going to be so many side plots going on, something like The Big Lebowski, you know, where it's like everything's going to tie together somehow, but there's so much going on to relate to, like, the littlest thing. It's going to be great.
If there was more violence in this, I would almost think it was a Quentin Tarantino movie.
Right?
Like, it has that same feel to it. Just his brain works that way, and it would be such a cool movie.
Yeah, I could see that too, yeah. Off topic, how great would it be for those directors to work together? The Coen Brothers and Tarantino?
Dude, he's coming out with
the Hateful Eight. Yeah.
That's it. I don't know, I think, like, I don't know. I hold the Coens above Tarantino.
I kind of do too, but I still respect Tarantino.
Nah, fuck him.
I love Tarantino.
With this, I'm so excited to see... What I think they do the best is show us imbeciles being foolish.
Yes.
And I'm so excited to see how they do that. I'm Absolutely. Always really excited to see that.
That's Fargo in a nutshell right there. Yeah.
Well, Burn After Reading.
Oh, Burn After Reading too, yeah.
Oh my gosh, Burn After Reading.
Yes.
They're doing it in a different era too. Like
right.
The 40s, the 50s. Like, that's going to be so much fun. Yes.
I feel like we need to go and see Burn After Reading again.
I have it.
Let's watch it.
I had a lot of fun with that.
I think it's on HBO right now.
I don't have that, but I do have it.
What do you have and what don't you have?
It. I don't have it.
Oh, okay.
Makes a lot of sense.
Thank you for clearing
that. Hello, Georgie.
Nice. So
thoughts? Black Lantern? Goddess?
Don't everybody speak at once.
Dude,
he asked you guys by name specifically. Yeah. So.
Powercast. Big Powercast. Awesome. Cool retro feel. With today's actors acting like they probably would act now, acting back then. Awesome. Very cool. Looks awesome. I say awesome like way awesome. Too much.
There's nothing wrong with the word awesome.
Yeah, that's awesome, dude.
I say you know too much.
He says like too much.
I do. I try to stop myself from doing that, but
that's all right. Goddess doesn't say anything too much. Whenever you're ready.
Nope.
I'm right here. Thoughts?
Thoughts.
It's a little too close.
Thoughts.
That's better. Yep. Definitely agree with everything.
Wow. You see the Black Lantern face palm.
You're welcome.
I'm sorry, Fangirl. Did I cut you off? Were you going to say something? No?
No, but I think you just cut the goddess off.
I'm sorry. What were you going to say?
It's just something stupid. Did anyone else think it was funny that they got George Clooney to be like a Caesar-y character. And when it was in like the 90s, he was like his haircut. He had the Caesar haircut.
He did. Yeah, he did.
I think that's what makes him perfect, is that exactly. He is that exact character. Did you catch the little blip in the trailer where he was looking into the camera and he like brushed his teeth with his finger?
Yeah.
Oh, that is such, such a him move. And in the 40s too, or 50s, you know, whatever it's taking place. It's awesome.
You know, and
did I say awesome yet?
No, I don't think you did.
Oh, well, what it do looks you think awesome.
It's, oh, right. Awful?
Awesome.
Oh, some.
Some awesome. Of it will be all.
All. Okay, got it.
And you could argue that the characters of Clooney and Tatum are kind of playing how they're viewed in cinema now. You know, like, Tatum is the pretty boy dancer, and Clooney is the aged, well-known actor. You know, they're kind of playing themselves in a way, but in this different era.
That's a great
I think that's kind of cool. Mm. I can't speak for any of the other actors. I don't think Josh Brolin is a fixer, but I don't know. But
I haven't seen him. Have you seen a bad Josh Brolin movie, though?
Not off the top of my head, no.
Wasn't he in... I have never seen
Casper.
Casper.
Was he in Casper?
No.
I liked Casper anyway. It's fine. I was gonna say,
I don't think he was in Casper. Like
that was Bill Pullman.
Yeah, it was.
Oh, yeah.
I think you're thinking of Christina Ricci.
Nope. It's
Christina you're thinking of Adam's Family.
Josh Brolin. Christina Ricci. Now you're thinking of Christopher Lloyd. Wait, you're talking about Back to the Future.
You don't get to say when I have thoughts and then tell me what they are.
6 degrees of everything.
That's not how thoughts work.
We can do this all night.
Nope.
Oh, you're right. So anyway.
Anyway.
Yep.
Your thoughts?
I gave them already. Awesome. Oh, wait, that's your thought?
Hey, come on. It's awesome. It's awesome.
Anyone else before we move on?
Well, yes.
Okay.
Because you only called two people out by name. Well, obviously.
I just
yeah, you know. It's.
I just asked you, and then you said I cut her off, so I went back to her.
Bunch of jokes.
All of us. Yep. All of us. I know. Actually, no. I don't have too much to say about this.
Oh, my God. Thank goodness we didn't miss any of this shit.
I know, right? But no, I think out of all the trailers that we saw this week, this is the one that I am most looking forward to.
I would agree to that, yeah.
And, yeah. It just looks like a lot of fun. I love, love, love Tilda Swinton.
As do I. She's not in enough.
No, she's not. And
you know what? She was really good in Benjamin Button.
Oh, I didn't actually see that.
Yeah.
I actually haven't seen her in a lot of things, but I just love her in general, so.
I've seen her once, and that's enough.
What? Once is enough? What did you see her in?
Wait, did you see her in
joke.
Once is enough?
Huh? I mean, I still need to see Only it's Lovers Left Alive.
What? See what?
Only Lovers Left
Say
Alive.
Stay Alive.
I don't know what that is.
It's that vampire movie with Tom Hiddleston.
Don't know it. Sorry.
Anyway. but yeah, no, I'm super, super looking forward to this. And it... And, you know, it looks awesome.
Yep.
Yes.
Moving
it's
on.
A quote.
Cool. So powercast and awesome.
Yeah. Powercast and awesome. Yeah, right. Moving on to our final trailer for the night, which is a trailer Redux, which is The Revenant.
Only safe thing to do is track a new course back up online.
Then what we gonna do? Sit out there like a bunch of goddamn ducks?
You and your half-breed son get to walk on out?
I'm talking to you.
Proper thing to do would be to finish him off quick.
He's to be cared for as long as necessary.
I understand.
Get away! Help!
Now, we did discuss this about a month and a half ago, and there's not a whole lot more to discuss with this, but this is the first official trailer, because there's actually a little bit of plot revealed in this instead of just teaser. They revealed what actually happens to Glass, the lead character. Yes, Fangirl.
Which is still completely confusing, and I still have no fucking clue what's going on.
Well,
read the Wikipedia.
Explain.
Something of, oh. Does that help a lot more than just watching the trailer? Okay. Yeah.
Nobody does that.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Yes, Black Lantern.
Oh, no, I do that.
Yes.
I read Wikipedia.
Yes, the character of Glass, which is Leonardo DiCaprio, is a fur trapper, and...
Giggity.
At one point, and this is true to his story now, actual accounts of his life vary, but everything traces back to this bear attack that he had. And at one point, he was savagely mauled by a bear and then left for dead out in the wilderness.
Why are you laughing?
Wow.
He was savagely mauled by a bear and left for dead in the wilderness. And she goes...
Because she's the goddess of gore. These things amuse her.
You're a monster.
She's the goddess of gore, man.
Oh, shit.
You're like some kind of goddess of gore. Yep. That's awesome.
But then his subsequent trek back to civilization in order to try and exact revenge on those who left him there. A couple of things off the bat. The first thing I'm going to say is Tom Hardy's character, when he says, he was buried right. You go back and look at the trailer, he was not fucking buried right. He's buried in like 2 inches of dirt.
I think that's the whole. I think that's the point of Tom Hardy's character, though.
Yeah, like.
Which he is nailing that accent, by the way.
What accent is that?
That accent he's hitting, like the kind of mountain man. He was buried in right way. He was just
like you couldn't really understand what he was saying.
Man, it's just like, fuck, it's like gibberish. It's from like Blazing Saddles, like authentic mountain pioneer man gibberish. Yeah. Man, it's just fantastic.
Yeah. That's genuine pioneer gibberish. Hardy.
Every one of his roles now, he has to have an accent or talking like this. You know, Mad Max, cool. He's got shit in his mouth, you know, and Dark Knight Rises, he's got shit on his mouth, or he has an accent. It's like, can't just Tom Hardy have his own voice for once?
I feel like Taylor Soldier Spy.
That was the only good example recently. We brought that up a lot in recent weeks.
Because I love that movie.
That's okay. But yeah, so the character wasn't buried at all, and they're like, oh, he was buried right. No, he wasn't, asshole, whatever.
He was buried right for the bear to come back and eat him.
Yeah. Ah, is that what it was?
It was
num nums.
I think that's the point. I think they're trying to prove they're because they didn't. I don't. In the first trailer that we saw, I don't remember Tom Hardy being necessarily a bad guy, but
I think he just an asshole, right?
And I think that's what I'm saying. Right. I think that's what we're trying to pick up in this trailer is that Tom Hardy is
the villain,
the fucking devil, dude.
Right.
He's doing super shit on purpose.
Awesome. Right.
He probably even knew that he wasn't dead.
Yeah, he
was like,
really
he's buried. He's fine.
Yeah.
Again.
And another thing is, I worry about the historical accuracies of this film.
There we go.
Fangirl.
Was he talking about Leonardo DiCaprio, or was he talking about Leonardo DiCaprio's son?
I think he was talking about...
Good question.
Was he talking about the bear?
I thought he was talking about DiCaprio.
But that's the way... It could have been the way that it was edited, too, right?
Like, that's true. Because
he was saying, like, if he was saying... Because Leonardo DiCaprio is like, there's a son involved, and he's trying to get revenge on the people.
It sounded
so maybe it was like he was saying to somebody that the kid was buried, right?
That's possible. Possible.
I don't know. Like, I couldn't really tell from the trailer.
From the editing of the trailer, it makes you lead that it's talking about DiCaprio, because right after that, it shows him in a show.
Right. Yeah. But you don't know necessarily.
Right.
That's
great.
That's the trailer magic.
Very linear.
Yeah,
we won't know till the movie
comes
out.
From one, the beginning to the end, to the middle to the front.
Right.
To the windows, to the wall.
Yeah.
The
sweat just from my balls.
Yep. Whoa, didn't need that part.
You got it.
Until the cat licks on my balls.
Whoa!
Who's the quietest when I gotta say something weird?
Because you pick those moments. Because you pick those moments.
Yeah. So your pickup was awesome, by the way. It was awesome.
Thank you.
Moving on.
Okay.
But from what I've read about Glass, I know.
I forgot to breathe for a second. Okay.
Her soul almost came out from that one.
Don't worry, I got it.
Jeez.
Thanks.
Because I'm a redhead.
From what I've read about Glass, I do know that he was married to a Native American, but. As far as him having a son and the son traveling with them and the son being murdered, I believe that is entirely fiction. So
don't even know that the boy was murdered in the movie.
It seems pretty obvious that the boy is murdered.
It is?
Yeah.
I just know that the sun is
dead. I was
dead.
Distracted when I was watching.
I was confused when I was watching, so...
It seems pretty clear that something happened to the sun. It appears that the sun was either murdered,
maybe they buried him
dead.
Something that's possible too. But
I swear Leo had that bear too. Turned the gun around. I thought he blew his face off.
Yeah.
But you know, old school weaponry.
Yeah.
Probably went through his ear.
Yeah. Probably like it got through like half an inch of that bear skin because it was like there's no power behind
the bear skin or bear skin.
The bear's skin.
Fair enough.
The bear's bear skin.
Oh, so wait, was the bear not... The bear wasn't wearing any clothing?
Big bear chasing me.
It was Mayor McBear. That's
Mayor
it was.
McBear.
Honey for everybody.
Bear's like... Anyway.
Mayor McBear.
Bear.
Obviously, this movie is going to be, you know, slightly dramatized for Hollywood, but...
No, really?
Slightly.
Really?
Did you see that trailer?
Well, it's also very stylized because of the director. Alejandro, what's his last name? Iñárritu, I think is how I pronounce his last name. It's just his style. I mean, you see that style in Birdman. You saw it in Babel. You know, it's that style of filmmaking that we see in this. And I love that style, but it's very dramatized, very much so. And I'm very much looking forward to this. I think this is one of the... are you okay there?
Me or...
You.
She just drank the whole thing.
I just drank
You're like mystified by it.
I swear that was full a second ago.
No, it wasn't. There was a lot of...
Holy
there wasn't
hell.
That much water left in there.
She's a camel.
Yeah, she's got that second hump she's got to fill full of water.
Where's your other hump? Wait, no, move on.
Yeah.
So, what are your guys' thoughts on this trailer?
Want to see it? What's the release date? Tell me now.
I'll watch it.
The limited release is December 25th.
Ooh.
Yeah, comes out
on
Christmas.
Won't see it then.
All right.
But when nationwide release is a couple weeks later.
Okay.
So, because they're getting out before the new year so they can get it in for Oscar season.
Right. January 8th, the same time that a horror movie comes out?
Probably, yep. Yeah.
That weekend after everybody's back to work
and everything.
Yep. Yep.
That means I'll be able to be over Star Wars by then and be
focus
on this.
Yes.
What's Star Wars?
Maybe when you're older, I'll tell you.
As I said the first time, it looks awesome.
Yeah, no, it does, but I'm probably less interested than most people in this
room. Because you're confused?
Because I'm super confused.
Doesn't make you want to understand the story, though? It's not giving you that?
No, it really, really wasn't.
Punch in the nuts?
Punch to the nuts.
Oh.
Definitely
not
that.
A boot to the head?
Is that feeling I have?
Yep.
I mean, I don't know what it is. It's just, it's not doing anything for me.
Oh. Okay. It's fair. Black Lantern, Goddess.
Oh, I had my thing. I'm good.
But yeah, I'll probably still see it, by the way. Just say.
Okay. Did you just do a John Cena? What the fuck was that?
It's hard to tell.
Two fingers I cannot move. I was going like that. I was pointing with three of my fingers. I would have been pointing with the other two, but I can't move them.
Goddess, anything? No?
I don't... I mean, what else can I say that hasn't
yay
been
nay.
Said?
Yay or nay?
Yay or nay. You know, I say Frey-hey.
Yay nay?
Oh, no. Oh,
say
no.
Nay, hey, Frey-hey.
It's begun.
No. Damn it, you did it again.
She's summoning the Dark One.
And only she can.
That's true.
I'm interested.
Okay.
Theaters or no?
Yes, because it also looks pretty.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think I would want to see it in the theater because it looks pretty, not necessarily for the plot and the confusingness of it.
You know, you can see it on Tuesdays.
That's
Cinemark.
That's probably what I'll do.
For $5.50.
What was the name of that
Minismark.
Minismark, wow. All
right. Greek or Greek.
Getting into our feature presentations, we do have a lot coming out the next couple weeks, but we'll get through them pretty quick. First one that we have is Bridge of Spies. Now, this is a Tom Hanks film, which we actually didn't discuss on this podcast because there haven't been too many trailers or press releases for it.
Nothing really happened with this movie.
Really? I've seen like one.
It happened quick, though.
Yeah.
Because all of a sudden, there was like, hey, Tom Hanks is in a new movie. And it's like, whoa.
Yeah, my thoughts exactly. I was like, oh, okay. Good to see Tom Hanks again, but where has this been? I haven't seen any trailers in theaters. I've seen like one or two TV spots.
I've seen a lot of TV. I think I saw one. I don't know. I feel like I've seen a lot.
Hmm. That's interesting. Is it all been on YouTube?
No.
No?
No.
TV. That guy said that. TV.
I pretty much catch a lot of... I see a lot of ads for it.
Yeah. Mm.
See ads on YouTube and...
Well, you guys have obviously seen it more. What is this film about?
Tom Hanks is like a lawyer,
okay.
But not like a government lawyer or anything like that. Like he's a corporate lawyer or like tax lawyer or something like that. Something not too interesting. And then for some reason, so there was this guy who was imprisoned. I'm not very good at this.
You're on a roll.
And then, no, but okay, so what I do know, the important part of it is that there was an American spy which was captured by the Russians?
Yep.
Was it the Russians?
Cold War.
Yeah.
Okay.
Russians, and then there was a Russian spy captured by the Americans. And Tom Hanks' character is the lawyer who they decided, oh, you're the person that we want to negotiate the exchange of the two.
Mm. Well, that's interesting. I find that interesting. Dystopian? Do you have any thoughts on this?
I haven't seen much. I saw, actually, for the trailers for today, I saw a trailer because it was an
yeah.
advertisement.
Oh, a trailer attached to a trailer?
That was the first I'd actually heard or seen anything about it.
So I'm not the only one on this. Okay.
yeah, I'm the only one who's actually seen
it. It looked kind of interesting, but like I said, I only saw like a 30-second advertisement.
Right.
I don't know. It didn't make me really want to go out and see it.
Yeah.
From right. what I saw.
And obviously, you've been seeing some advertisements, but maybe we just don't watch enough TV to see it
great
enough.
Thing.
But,
yeah, I watch
but I mean, you know what I mean. It's Tom Hanks. It's a thriller. Sounds cool.
Right. And I mean,
I would probably Netflix.
I love Tom Hanks, but it's like, I would have thought this would have been advertised more. Apparently, it's been getting advertised, but
yeah.
I don't know. Whatever circles I've been viewing, I just haven't seen it, you know?
Right.
I don't know, man. It seems like one of those movies where they would have done more. Especially since the time it's being released and everything. Like you felt like they would have done more publicity for it. But
you would think, yes.
I agree. I mean, most of what I've seen has been like YouTube advertisements and things like that. Like
right.
Dystopian was saying.
But I think because of the nature of this film, and I feel like, again, it may be in the right season. Like, is this like Oscar bait season?
I would say so, yes.
And I think this is what it kind of is. And with that being said, I feel like a lot of films which are aiming for that kind of thing don't necessarily advertise it on a mass media broad spectrum like that. Like, they don't do the whole, you know, viral thing where they just kind of put out a couple of trailers before the movie starts and they focus it, like, you know, it's not so much a big, huge, like, you know, the Hunger Games, where they have a lot of, like, viral media that comes out, you know, Facebook, Twitter, and stuff like that. Like, it's just not that kind of film.
Right. Okay.
Their cast is pretty substantial.
Well, read off some for me.
We got Amy Ryan.
Okay.
Who you would obviously know from Gone Baby Gone,
right,
Birdman,
right.
Mm-hmm. Some others. Alan Alda. I don't think I have to say what he's been in.
Yeah.
Tom Hanks is obvious. Joshua Harto, who was in The Dark Knight.
Oh,
who's
he? He was that scumbag that was trying to rip off Bruce Wayne.
Oh, there's rumors that he was going to be the Riddler in the next film.
Oh,
and
ooh.
They
but, yeah.
said, and that was the one the Joker wanted dead.
Yeah.
And then the only other person that I recognize is Dominic Lombardozzi.
Wait, what does he look like?
He was in Phone Booth. He's in Daredevil, but he was only in, like, one episode.
I think you're thinking of Colin Firth. No, I'm just kidding.
I know.
No, it's Colin Firth, actually.
Oh,
got
it.
Yeah. But, I mean, you know, it's got some pretty decent names.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's about all I recognize, though. All
right. Well, I mean, I haven't seen much. This is something I might catch when it's on Netflix. I mean, but nothing I've seen recently, again, with the very, very little I've seen, makes me want to go out to the theaters and see this.
Yeah, this is kind of one of those movies where, kind of like Saving Private Ryan, like, if it comes on FX, I'll be like, yeah, I'll sit here for 4 hours and watch it, because it's probably a three-hour movie, and it's,
yeah.
you know, hour of commercials and everything.
Yep.
yep.
Well said.
Thank you.
Not bad.
Moving on to our next feature presentation, which is Crimson Peak.
Yay!
Oh, boy. There has
really
been.
I want to see this.
Yeah, there is a ton of hype going in for this one amongst this room. Shut up.
Why?
I am really, really looking forward to this. This looks like a blast. Why don't you want to see this, Black Lantern?
Doesn't look good.
What?
You don't look good.
I think he's trolling us.
That's true.
No, I'm not trolling.
Why? Why doesn't it look good?
It looks like every other horror movie that's coming out right, like in the last 5 years.
It's Del Toro. It looks nothing like any other horror film.
All the animation and the scary hands and the weird ghouls and everything. It looks all the same.
How? And what horror films have you seen that look like this?
What are those? Oh, there was a Woman in Black.
Woman in Black look nothing like this.
Dude, I'm telling you, this trailer's terrible.
The coloring, like, just look at how vivid the colors are.
Oh, you're right, the coloring, that's what makes this a good movie.
No, but I'm just saying...
No, it's Tom Hiddleston that does that.
No, I'm saying, look at the Woman in Black, and look at how that's colored in the grayscale in the Woman in Black. Then look
at
Crimson Peak.
That's not what I'm talking about, though. What I was talking about was the... It's trying to be a good horror movie, and it just looks like every other horror movie.
I don't think that it's necessarily trying to be a good horror film. I think it's trying to be a pretty horror film.
True, but it's also trying to be a classic horror film. It is old school horror. It's, you know, the ghost knocking on the door and jiggling the handle. And
don't,
you know,
go
don't go down, don't go to that level. Don't go in that
don't
room.
That way.
Doesn't
yeah.
interest me
Never
at
go
all.
That way.
But that's old school horror. That's something I love.
It's straight to the cast.
Never go that way.
They all have English accents, right? They all have English accents.
I think so, yeah. Is that why you hate it?
Typical. Woman in Black. And all, I'm telling you, all those other movies that came out like the same time as Woman in Black. I can't think of them all right now, but they were just the same fucking concept. It's like, it's a haunted house. Who gives a shit?
Okay.
Okay.
Well, dystopian, thoughts?
He doesn't care.
No, watch, he'll say he doesn't care, and no one will give him time of day. Like, oh, yeah, that's
because
a good
he doesn't
thought.
Care he doesn't, because he doesn't have a heart.
That's true.
Why should he care?
He doesn't have a heart.
He didn't want to see Good Dinosaur.
Dystopian, what do you think?
Oh, no, I think you guys already summed up how I think. You guys did really well. You've been paying attention. That makes me feel wanted and cared about. I appreciate that.
Because we listened to
you. I mean, it's Del Toro, right? So that's
right.
Cool. Mm-hmm. I like his stuff. It does look pretty cool. I haven't paid too close attention to it, but it's got Hiddleston, which is great. It kind of makes me think of like a Fall of the House of Usher kind of vibe.
Yes, yes.
And that makes me interested. So if we were all going to go out and see it, maybe at a Cinemark theater on a Tuesday for $5, I might see it.
Okay.
Yay, let's go.
What's coming out
love
soon?
It, love, oh, it, love, oh, it, love it, love it, love it, love it. I love it.
Jesus.
Nice. Cross the streams, Eric.
Goddess, fangirl, any final thoughts?
I mean, you all know my thoughts on this. Mm-hmm. I don't like horror films, but I'm going to see this because of Tom Hiddleston. I still think that, because originally... It was Benedict Cumberbatch who was cast. I still think he would have been great in this. But, you know, Hiddles is also going to be fine. I mean, I know it. But, but no, it looks good. And as you said, I think the colors actually do add a lot to this
yes.
film.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And, you know, and that is what sets it apart from every other horror film that's, you know, that's been, you know, coming around lately, I think,
right.
where Agreed. They try to stay in the grayscale.
Right.
I will give you the color thing. It does look very colorful. Yeah. Still not interested in the movie.
You know, the only other horror film recently that I think you could compare this to is Mama, because that was Del Toro. And you could say that style was like Crimson Peak.
Also a terrible movie.
I didn't see it.
Mama wasn't that bad.
But then
also a terrible movie.
And again, the ending.
The ending was crap.
But
everything up till the ending was okay.
Did Del Toro just direct this, or did he write it as well?
Oh, I don't know. I should look that up.
Because
his writing is a little spotty.
Not the
greatest. That's true. Yeah. Very true.
He is a director and a writer.
Oh.
Yeah. So
is he the only writer?
No, Matthew Robbins.
Okay. Yeah, because when he writes English dialogue, it can sometimes
just not,
be
you know,
off.
But I mean, the visuals of his work, like I like a lot of that. Mm-hmm. So
agreed. Moving on.
That probably would have gotten a better review.
Our next feature presentation is Goosebumps. Okay. On the other gambit of horror, which I just don't care about, this has actually been getting some decent press as of late for those people who are like, if you're a real big fan of the books, you might actually have a good time with this.
Probably just for nostalgia. Just like, oh, that's...
Yeah.
That's, nostalgia.
That's Fred. Yeah. And oh, that's Bob.
Yeah, just
because
you recognize it. Yeah.
Yeah, Fred and Bob. Yeah.
Don't you remember Fred and Bob?
Yeah,
the Freddy Goosebumps and Bobby Goosebumps.
Right, right.
The Goosebumps brothers. That's what those books were about, right?
Wait, I think you're getting confused with the Hardy Boys.
Oh, that's right.
Yes, yes, yes.
Not to be confused with Tom.
Freddy and Bob Goosebumps.
I mean, I don't know how about this one. I mean, this is a...
I think it's stupid.
It's PG horror, which, you know, is totally. Never good horror. But sometimes it can work. I mean, a good example would be like Monster House, which came out many years ago. But that was actually a decent example of how to do something PG, but is still like a good story, despite the fact that it's not very horrific.
Was
you know?
It like Paranorman? Wasn't that PG?
Yeah, Paranorman. Paranorman a very really good example.
I like
Paranorman.
That was
fantastic.
One of the best, like, horror films I've seen in the past 10 years.
Yeah. Yes. And the story was great in that.
Yes.
Yes.
The visuals were really great.
Now, are we going to get the story from Paranorman in this? Fuck no.
No.
But
are they doing like a bunch of stories wrapped into one with this?
Yes.
It's just like, it's not even like a Goosebumps story.
Yep, you're right. Okay.
It's just the monsters coming out of the books.
Right.
Right.
So it's basically
like fucking Jumanji.
Yeah.
Almost.
Yes. A bunch of shit goes wrong.
Yes.
And
I think we said that last time.
So it's kind of scary. It'll have like those little scary moments.
Right.
Where like the monkey,
right.
The lion.
Little jump scares, right. Right.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yep.
Okay.
But stupid.
But stupid.
And no Robin Williams.
Oh.
Is that stupid?
That is actually, that is really stupid.
Okay. That's a very good point. That poodle with fangs and red eyes is very stupid.
Who else is in it other than Jack Black?
Like, not really any notable people.
Amy Ryan.
Who's the boy kid?
Boy kid?
The boy kid.
Bring me the boy child.
You got the
you remind me of the
troll babe. If you want the
Thank you for those who caught that reference.
Amy Ryan, Jillian Bell, Ken Marino, Houston Sage. There's a couple good people in here.
The boy child.
Oh.
The boy
child. Dylan Minnette.
I don't know who the fuck the boy child is. And of course he was born 10 years after me to the day.
That's why he's a boy child.
What are you trying to say?
What?
I don't know.
I don't either.
What are you trying to say?
Oh, God.
He was in Prisoners.
I'm saying he was in Prisoners?
Yes,
yes
he was.
Well
yeah,
said.
You're welcome.
Thanks.
He was the older brother in that, yeah.
Okay. He was in something I'm saying no else. One should watch this because it's too scary for little kids and it's not
too stupid
good.
For
yes,
right.
too stupid everybody
for
else.
The rest of the world.
Yeah. Fair assessment.
I think if it's too scary for little kids, I'll watch it.
Okay.
That sounds creepy, but I don't mean it in a creepy way. I said I was reading, so I didn't say it in a very accurate thing. So what's the next one?
Moving on to our next feature presentation, which is Gem and the Holograms. This has kind of snuck under the radar as of late. I remember the trailer for this came out almost a year ago now.
Yeah, it was a long time
ago. Yeah. And the entire internet just said, fuck this noise. they saw this and they basically said, oh, look, Gem is now Justin Bieber. They basically gave her the exact same origins and they haven't released another trailer since. Mm-hmm. They basically said, we're just going to sit on it. Now, supposedly, this is coming out next week, but I haven't seen anything on this recently.
Yeah, this I haven't seen anything.
I think they're going to push this back because they haven't done any advertising for this because it's been, like, reviled. Like, people just hated it online, and people are like, we don't want to see this. So it's almost like the studio just wants to back off and maybe do a rewrite or a second pass on the editor or something. I don't know, but I see this tanking. I see this tanking hard.
Is this Dakota Fanning?
No, it's not Dakota Fanning.
Who is
it? I don't think there's anybody.
There's no one really notable in it. There's Juliette Lewis. She's the only real big name.
Why did I think it was?
But she's not
Fanning.
Like Gem.
No, she's not Gem. No.
But she is
or
at
a
least
hologram.
A B minus actor, Riss, actoress.
Actress.
Actress.
Asterix.
Asterix.
She was in The Other Sister.
She was in a lot. She was in Cape Fear.
Yep. Yeah, I don't know any of these people.
No, the lead actress was in something notable. I can't recall what it was.
What's her name?
I don't remember what the girl playing Jem. I don't know her name. The entire cast.
Oh, sorry, Sharknado.
Oh, Shark. Oh, that's right. She was in Sharknado, which is the one thing you don't want on your damn resume. So, this looks awful. They haven't advertised it at all as of late. I'm wondering if the studio is just thinking, okay, no one wants to see it, so why Oscar even bait. Spend money on advertising? You know? What?
Oscar bait.
Powercast?
Powercast?
Oh, gosh.
It's got both.
Oh, yeah.
Absolutely. It looks awesome.
It's going to be awesome.
I suspect if this is getting released next week, which I still have a feeling it's going to get pushed back a little more. If it is released next week, it's just going to tank hard. I don't know what else to say. Everyone who was a fan of Jem and the Holograms is just looking at this and saying this is terrible.
Yeah, no, it's going to tank.
Yep. So, moving on from that, we have Paranormal Activity, The Ghost Dimension.
Also going to... Yeah. Well, no, probably not going to tank. No. Because people will still go see it.
People are swarming for these films. I don't know why. Paul,
looks
for
so
one.
So terrible.
Oh, this is the one where
what is scary about these movies?
I don't know.
Well, oh my God, the sheet
what
moved.
What they took in the first movie, to me at least, that was scary, when you could not see the demon thing, but you heard it and you saw
now you can
like
see
the footprints,
it.
They took that element out of it and you can see it. And you're like, well, that's not really that scary.
Yeah, there's a lot. It's just, it seems like just jump scares, man.
It is. It's all jump scares now. Yeah.
And like doors slamming.
Right. And they're trying to create like a mythos in this, you know, like trying to create a backstory.
Scary.
But it... The whole story is shit by this point, you know? Yeah. And then by the fourth one, they started bringing in, like, virgin sacrifices what the hell's going on with this?
Wait, was the fifth one the marked ones?
Yes.
So this is the sixth one. Yeah.
And supposedly this is the final one.
Yeah. It's like Saw. Like, it just won't stop.
They're saying this is the final one, but you take that, take that with a grain of salt.
Didn't they say that about Fast and Furious?
Well, no, they never really officially stopped Fast and Furious. They never said, oh, well, this is going to be the last one.
No, they should have.
But no, they have come out and said that I think part 9 is going to be the final one.
Oh,
I'm sorry. There's more coming?
Yeah.
Wait,
I'll still see all of them, but, you know.
Right. I'm pretty sure they said that part 9 for Fast and Furious is going to be
the
final one.
What was
the
last one that came out?
Seven.
Was it seven?
Seven.
Oh.
Fast Seven, yeah.
There's going to be at least...
Furious Seven.
Furious Seven, yeah. So 8 and 9 are going to come out, but 9 should be the last one.
Okay.
No, I don't care about this. Nope. And this has something to do with, you know, spirit photography and, you know, and being able to record the ghost now and...
Yeah, it's stupid.
Yeah.
I found this magic camera from
this magic camera.
I can see ghosts.
I remember when we were talking about this for the actual trailers, we came up with like a better plot for it, and we should have done that instead. I can't remember
what
it was.
I forget. We have to go back and listen. Yeah,
because I'm pretty sure we were like, I'm sure whatever we said was better than whatever they have. So,
So moving on to our next feature presentation, which is Rock the Cash Bar. Now, this is unfortunately was one we
cash
didn't get.
Cash Bar?
I'll rock that. Cash bar.
Cat box.
Cat box.
Casbah.
Okay. What? However you pronounce it.
It's not.
It's Casbah.
Casbah.
I know. That's guys. I wasn't sure. I didn't know it was Casbah.
You gotta say it like you're from Boston. Rock the Casbah.
Casbah.
Wow.
In the yard.
Mark Wahlberg. Casbah.
Now, unfortunately, we didn't get a chance to talk about this one because in that week we took off, that was would have been one of our trailers, but. I mean, just got skipped. But I'm going to say, I kind of want to see this. I still don't really know what the movie is about, unfortunately.
Looks fucking awesome.
Yes, Fangirl.
I think it's about Bill Murray is a talent scout.
Okay.
And I don't know if he's working with Zooey Deschanel or not. But then he sees like this girl who was singing in somewhere in the Middle East. I don't know what it was. And then they want to go and get her to be a talent. But then, you know, the people were, but she's like, no, I don't sing outside of, you know, where I am. I can't leave this place or, you know, I just can't do this. And then, And then the people, like her village or whatever, are like, no, you can't go. And then so he tries to just take her and just like, no, you're going to be great. We're going to take you and make you famous and awesome and everything. And then Bruce Willis is like,
is like he with the military?
No, not a mission. Mercenary kind of group, okay. I think. I don't think he's part of the military, but like, so he was hired, I think, by Bill Murray to, as like a protective convoy.
Gotcha.
I think that is what I've got. Yeah. So.
Okay.
It looks good. I want to see it.
Well, the parts I've seen in the clips are all pretty funny. I like what's going on here, and. I mean, anything with Bill Murray, I'll see.
And anything with Bruce Willis, I'll see.
Anything with Zooey Deschanel, I'll see.
Oh, okay then. We're all sold on someone.
And Taylor Kinney and Kate Hudson.
Oh, yeah, Kate Hudson's also on it.
Dystopian, who are you sold on?
Ooh,
Danny McBride. Sarah Baker.
I mean, dude. Bill Murray, yeah. But I haven't seen much about it, but it sounds kind of interesting.
Yeah.
Because I told it.
I think I just saw the trailer for the first time like a week ago.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, probably me too, but I've seen so many that I feel like I've seen a lot more.
Nothing. Why do you don't constantly do this today?
What do you
It seems like a power cast.
That's a good comment.
Yeah, power cast.
I'll Puppy see it on Tuesday.
Puppy power.
Why did you gasp?
I lost her.
Yeah, yeah.
Was there a cartoon where there were puppies?
There was Pound.
Yeah, there was about 38 of them.
But it was Scrappy-Doo.
Scrappy-Doo who would say puppy power.
Yes.
Puppy he was from power. Scooby-Doo. His nephew.
What was his relation? Oh, thank you.
You got it.
His nephew here.
I got you, dog. Get it, dog?
Nope.
Moving into our final feature presentation, which is The Last Witch Hunter.
Was that
Vin Diesel
one.
Yes.
Okay.
And what's her name? Rose?
McGowan?
No.
Byrne?
No.
Bud?
Yeah, Mud. Thy name is Mud.
No, not Mud. Bud.
Bud.
Thank you.
I know. I mean, I haven't seen Citizen Kane. I get this.
Rose
Did that
Mud.
Just go?
Pfft. Yes.
Okay.
No, I heard Mud. Sorry.
Get the mud out, cheese.
God.
Leslie.
Yeah, Rose Leslie. Yeah.
I don't know who that is.
That's Ygritte from Game of Thrones.
Oh, yep. I don't watch Game of Thrones.
She was also in season one of Downton Abbey.
Yep. Yes.
Don't watch. That either.
We recently saw a movie called Honeymoon. Maybe? She was in that.
How was it?
That was actually pretty good.
Good.
Yeah. The ending fucked with you.
Right on. That's the kind of movie I like.
This one, like I've said before, it looks kind of generic. It's just one of those generic mystical action films. But it looks like, you know, for a one-off action film, it could be fun. I know they've already greenlit the sequel, but I kind of want to see this.
Oh, now, Elijah Wood is in this.
Yes, Elijah Wood is in this.
Oh, yeah.
If I recall, when we talked about this, mm-hmm. everyone else was like, oh, this looks so stupid. And I was the only one was like, I want to see it.
Well, no.
Pipe down.
I'm not saying that.
Michael Caine is also in this.
Yep.
Yeah, he's his mentor.
And we had said,
I still want to see
you know,
it.
If Michael Caine is on your side in the beginning, be careful because he's probably betraying you by the end.
Yeah. Unless you're Batman.
Then he doesn't betray
say,
you.
What?
I do agree. I when I first saw this, I thought it looked a little stupid, but I still thought it could be fun.
I mean, I still think it looks really stupid, but I just super want
to
see it.
That's what I was waiting for him to say. But I still thought, this still looks stupid.
But I still super want to see it.
The stupid?
I mean, maybe on a Tuesday, but...
I don't think I'd see it in theaters, but if, like, we... Redboxed it or Netflixed it. Yeah.
So that means you're saying that we don't have to ask you when we go see it in the theaters?
What would that fucking matter? Tell me that much.
Yeah, because you wouldn't go anyway.
Not true.
Always farting.
There's a lot of hate being thrown around this podcast.
Always.
This podcast is like.
That's true.
Any other thoughts?
I digress.
Kill this podcast. Make it stop.
Wow. Holy shit.
I don't think there needs to be that much animosity.
You want to fight about it?
Yeah.
Good.
I'll kick your ass and you know it.
That's good because Mike said he wanted to fight you.
Yeah.
I did what now?
Don't worry about it. Like you'll find out in a minute.
That was like a cat. Like if somebody needed a noise for an alarm, but it was just cat noises. Meow, 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 meow,
meow.
I feel like everybody has picked a fight with me tonight.
Shut up.
I didn't.
You shut up.
When?
Me?
You didn't. You
okay.
Did. You totally did.
No, you didn't hear what Kim was saying about you when you were in the bathroom.
This is ridiculous.
Let's end this.
She was told you need to kill it.
Well, most of us want to see Last Witch Hunter, so I want to thank the goddess for coming by.
Yep.
Bud.
I want to thank Black Lantern for coming by.
I'm pretty awesome.
Yeah.
So. Oh, wow.
Yep. I want to thank the fangirl for coming by.
I will fight you and I will win.
Wow. I want to thank the dystopian for coming by.
Always a pleasure.
You're a liar.
And I, once again, am the projectionist. And just to let you guys know, the next time we record is going to be a little bit of a different format. We are going to be recording our Halloween podcast.
Ooh. I think somebody's car alarm's going off.
More than likely, we are not going to be discussing trailers on the next podcast, but we'll be discussing a particular topic that we love from this time of year. So,
Benedict Cumberbatch?
Probably not.
He's
going to be angry.
Benedict Pumpkin Patch?
Pumpkin Patch. The Great Pumpkin.
Be a good Halloween costume.
Nice.
Oh, yeah.
But we'll be doing that next week, just to let you guys know. So sorry if we miss a week of trailers. We'll try and catch up the following time, but... Just to let you know, hopefully you'll enjoy that. And I, once again, am the Projectionist. Thank you all for tuning in. Have a very good day. And take care.
We love you.